Ladies and gentlemen, Thunder fans, welcome to TIO Traeger Park for the NEAFL Round 19 action, where the NT Thunder takes on Southport Sharp. Thank you so much for coming along today to support your territory team, the Mighty Thunder. A huge thank you to all of our sponsors, especially Southern Cross Television, McDonald's, Alice Springs Town Council, Lasseter's Hotel Casino, McMahon Services, and Interact Indigenous Contractors. Tossing the coin today is Ms. Cattenhorn from Southern Cross Television.
Bit more, bit more. Yeah, that's it. That's perfect right there. Beautiful. Eagles are giving it to the Hawks. Good start at the moment.
All right, let's walk into it, eh?
Yeah, whenever you're ready, brother.
Hello and welcome to our coverage of the Round 18 NEAFL match between NT Thunder and Southport Sharks. A home game in Alice Springs for NT Thunder is being played at Traeger Park, the centre of Australian football. My name's Stan Coombe. Joining me in commentary, a gentleman who kicked a footy around here as a young fella plenty of times, I think, before he headed down south, won himself a McGarry medal and then played 100 AFL games for St Kilda and Brisbane. Welcome back to Alice Springs, Gilbert McAdam.
Oh, Stan, great to be here, brother. And yeah, obviously came back early this morning, flight from Melbourne, and I just get happy when I come home. And you know, when I come to football games, and I was very happy that I got the opportunity to watch my former club in the South Football Club that played the curtain raiser to this game, and they played the Westies Footy Club. And yeah, I'm quite proud because the boys had a good win, and apparently they've wrapped up their finals appearance because this is the last round. So yeah, it's a bit personal, but it's good. It's a very good personal, Stan, and great to see you yourself, brother. It's me and you go back a long way.
Yeah, we've done a lot of commentary from this ground and from this grandstand too, mate, and it is personal for you too. It's called the McAdam Bowden Grandstand, named after your family and another great local football family, of course, the Bowdens.
Yeah, look, and you know, thanks very much to the, you know, NTFL or the CAFL and the people who obviously made the decisions, you know, for the people to be able to recognise our family, McAdams, and what we've done. We're very grateful for that, and you know, it's just reward, I suppose. That's what it is. And you know, I just like to think that you know, we can keep the flag flying, and you know, we might get some nephews and maybe some grandsons that might fly the flag for the McAdams eventually. Well, on this ground,
I think I saw a nephew with yours out there today, Adrian's son, Aiden, out there playing for South.
Yeah, he kicked a couple, but yeah, no, he's all right. He's got a bit to work to do, but he kicked a couple, and a couple of magic goals like his old man too.
Yeah, he certainly knew how to kick one or two. Now, this game at a different time slot for what was scheduled. There was flight delays, and Jeff, it was played at 3:30 as scheduled. It would have been in glorious conditions, a beautiful early August day in Alice Springs, 23 degrees, not even a zephyr of breeze. It just would have been perfect. Still, the conditions good, clear skies, no breeze, but the temperature has plummeted and it will continue to plummet too. An expected low of just 1 degree tonight. So cold conditions out there for these two sides. Might even suit Southport more than Thunder.
Well, the thing is, the Southport, obviously Southport in Gold Coast, well, they love the sun, just like the Territory boys. So I don't know. You know, I don't really, at the end of the day, I don't think it's really going to have an effect on the game. I think Territory Thunder second spot, and they want to sew up their second spot, and Southport chasing the five spots, so they've got a lot to play for. So all in all, there's a lot at stake tonight, Stan, and I think we're going to see it on the footy field.
Plenty of AFL experience out there, both clubs, a bit of a local flavour to it for NT Thunder too. Of course, Don Barry, five AFL games for Melbourne last year. Liam Patrick coming back to Alice Springs, played a lot of his junior footy here for Federal. And
I coached him at Federal's as a 17-year-old when he first started playing league football, and I actually gave him his first senior game. So, nah, me and Liam go back a long way, but it's just not the Thunder guys. It's also the Southport players, and Jared Brennan, well, that's a name we know very well. He's a Territory boy, ex-Southern Districts player. Great to see him in there, but also that name Hunt. Yeah. Now, Hunt obviously played with the Mighty Cats, and I played in a premiership with them and obviously went to the GWS. So, all in all, there's experience of AFL. Stan, take it over.
Here we go, NT Thunder versus Southport Sharks. Ryan Smith in the ruck up against Stephen Tyne there. In fact, big Christian Bock in the ruck. Southport, they'll all pile in over the top and the umpire will get to just run back in and do it all over again. The lights on full bore at Traeger Park. Magnificent sight. What a venue it is.
Absolutely, Stan. And there's no wind. There's no elements that's going to affect the game, mate. It's all going to be about football tonight.
Tamlin, quick kick out of the middle and Gibson Turner, the local one. Gibson, the twister Turner, takes a mark right on the 50. Short passes a beauty to Ewing, who dives low and takes a mark on the chest. And the master goal kicker will go back and line up from about 35 out.
Yeah, how appropriate is that? They get the first tap out of the centre bounce, and we spoke about Alice Springs. Well, Gibson Turner, obviously Alice Springs play, he's from Santa Teresa, and that's great for him because, you know, he's on his home ground, he's got his home people supporting him. You know, for him to get an early touch, that's great, but they've got to kick a goal now.
Darren Ewing, he doesn't miss too often, 35 out onto that trusty left boot, and he puts it straight through. Great start for Thunder. They've got a goal only a minute into the game. Darren Ewing kicks it, one straight goal, 6. Southport yet to score. Gibson Turner too. He was on Richmond's rookie list a few years back.
Yeah, he was. And look, that would have been a great experience for him. And, you know, at the end of the day, it's a positive thing. And it's a win-win situation, I believe, because, you know, he can pass it on to his sons or his grandkids, or he can pass it on to his nephews or his cousins. And that's what it's all about. If these young people from the communities want to play at that level, they need an insight. He'll give them that insight, Stan.
Not too late for him to get back into the big time either. Ryan Smith won the tap, but it's Hunt who'll burst out of the centre. The two-time premiership player for Geelong. Kick bounces inside the attacking 50 for Southport. Bugler there, the handball off to Ben Rioli. Gets his kick out wide at Motlop Marks, just inside the boundary line. Kicks up towards the wing looking for Liam Patrick. Ball off hands, tapped forward by Richard Tambling. There's some more of that AFL experience for NT Thunder. This time the ball over the boundary line. Dylan Troutman there for the Southport Sharks.
Yeah, great to see Liam back in there. And Richard Tambling, we'll talk about AFL experience. Well, he's been there and done that, that's for sure, Stan.
He's had a cracking season too for Thunder. He'd be high in the NEAFL Most Valuable Player Awards. Kick forward by Stephen Tyne. Got it up towards the wing for Southport. Cameron Islett, one of two Thunder players in there to apply a tackle. The umpire call for a ball up right on centre wing.
Yeah, just quickly, the ruckman, big Christian Bock. He's a big man. He's almost a metre taller than the anti-Thunder player, but it's going to be an interesting clash, that one.
Yeah, we always probably give away a bit in the ruck department, Thunder, certainly height-wise. You know, all up for dispute here on the wing. Tambling with his nose over it. Hunt applies a tackle. They probably run into each other at AFL level a couple of times. Rosier got a handball to Smith. Smith gave a further handball onto Emery. Emery kicks forward. Julia Lockwood with the mark. In between centre and centre, forward for Thunder. He goes out wide. Todd River side of the ground. Finds Gibson Turner, who takes the mark uncontested. Second possession for Gibbo. Another low spearing pass looking for Ewing. This time it didn't get to him on the full. Ewing takes the ball over the boundary line. Boundary thrown about 40 metres around from the Thunder goal. They're looking sharp.
They are. They've a great start by them. And Lockwood, he played a magnificent game against the Gold Coast last week, and he was the one that got him back in the game, Stan. So he needs to start early this week, because last week he didn't come in until later of the game.
He's doing the ruck work up inside the attacking 50. Might get another opportunity at it as well. Plenty of players over the top, and the umpire's called for a ball up. The footy's only about 30 metres out from Thunder's goal. They've got the only score on the board, 1-6, leading Southport, yet to score. Or player duck back into trouble there, the defender for the Sharks. Eventually, James Holland with the footy will kick out towards the halfback flank, the ball off hands and over the boundary line for another boundary throw-in. Small crowd of spectators over there. Most of them over this side of the ground.
Yeah, no, look, obviously there was a lot of supporters supporting the local competition, you know, before the curtain raiser. There's no doubt about it. A couple of them are going home, but, no, you'd like to think a few of them would stay back and watch this, because this is quality, this is sort of standard here.
Yep, it's a standard of football we only get to see once a year now in Alice Springs. Matt Rosier, there's a local lad. Gets out of the pack, ducked out of trouble, floating kick forward, and Chris Dunn's taking the mark. Right on the attacking 50 for Thunder. Ewing, one-on-one in the goal square. Liam Patrick drifting down in that direction as well now. It's taking a long time over this Chris Dunn, perhaps backing himself to go the distance.
Well, it wouldn't surprise me if he could kick this down, because I've seen him kick it from the 50 before, and it's only the first quarter, so they normally do it early.
51 out. It's going to drop in the goal square. Bumped out of the contest there, Patrick. Ryan Smith, the big ruckman, gets in and gets the crumbs. Got a handball out. Here's young Michael Hagen, twisting and turning, snapping towards goal. And through for one behind. I know you bumped into his dad earlier on, and what a legend he's been in Northern Territory footy.
Oh, look, absolutely. And I knew that name, and I was frightened to say it a couple of weeks ago because I didn't know that was his dad. But his dad is the great Normie Hagen, who played for the Pioneers Football Club, but also played with the West Adelaide Football Club in their Sandfall, but also the Buffalo Footy Club. Mm-hmm. He's a legend, Normie Hagen.
That he is. NTFL record for most goals in a game, 24. Pipped as an NT record by his nephew, Trevor Dew, here for Pioneer one day.
Unbelievable.
Footy on the wing, back to their NEAFL action. Ben Rioli gets a floating kick away for Thunder. Cameron Island underneath it, bumped off it. Matt Rosie looked like he copped one high, and I think the umpire's going to agree with that. Rosie is slow to get up. Little terror he is. Cut his teeth here for the West Football Club as a young man. We called a grand final that he played in as a 15-year-old.
Wow. That would have been a while ago.
It was, mate, it was. Motlop with the footy, centre wing, grandstand side. Just the short pass further afield, over to Sam Talbot. They didn't gain a lot of ground, and they won't with that one either. He's kicked into the man on the mark, Josh Hunt. The experienced campaigner, content to see the ball over the boundary line, boundary throw in. Thunder leading 1-1-7, Southport yet to score. Almost 6 minutes gone in the opening term.
Yeah, and Jared Brennan, we mentioned him before, he's started off in the forward line for the Southport Sharks.
Not seeing a lot of it either, is he?
No, he's not. But no doubt he's a player that you've got to watch, because you don't know when he's going to be dangerous, because on any given day he can win a game off his own boot.
Freakish skills. Neil Veve doing some ruck work there for Thunder. Talbot took the tap, got the kick forward. Good diving mark low to the ground, taken by Nicholas Crowley for the Sharks. Looked around for someone to play onto. Got the little handball away in the end, and now the short pass comes to the back flank area. Harrison Fraser's taken the mark. Kicks towards the wing for the Sharks. Julian Lockwood, good spoil away from behind. Liam Patrick picks up the footy.
Oh, great hands.
Slick hands. Here go Thunder, inside 50, off the boot of Motlop. Waiting for the crumbs. Ewing, soccer off the ground. Rolls close to goal, but it's going to be wide. It might be kept in play by Dunn. It is. He goes to ground, and the Sharks able to clear. A kick scrubbed out towards the half-back flank. Grand preferred the boundary, but Tambling takes it a couple of metres in and spears the pass low, hits Motlop on the chest, and Aaron Motlop to line up for goal from about 50 out.
Oh, look, great play by Tambling then to actually keep the ball in the first place, but he's got beautiful skills, and yeah, this is going to test Aaron, because he's right on the 50, and you know, he's not the longest kick going. On the run he's okay, but I reckon set shots, 50 is going to really test him. But it's early, it's first quarter, so normally you've got a bit of strength in those legs.
Famous Territory footballing family, the Motlops. The kick goes right in the goal. Plenty of Southport defenders back there, and they'll rush that one through from behind. Luke Hill doing the defensive work. Thunder move their score on to 1-2-8. Southport yet to score. Just over 7 minutes gone in the opening term.
Yeah, Thunder are dominating that much, Dan, that Southport have all the players, and if you look from the centre onwards to the Southport forward line, there's nobody there. They're all back because, you know what, they need to steady the ship a bit.
Absolutely no one forward of centre for Southport. Now they start to move in that direction as the ball goes up towards the wing. Ben Rioli there, good defensive play, sees the ball over the boundary line. Boundary throwing on the Todd River side of the ground. Veve will do the ruck work. He's up against Kieran Brennan. Certainly giving away a few inches, Veve. Probably had the better of that in the end. And now they'll get a kick forward. Thunder. It goes towards centre-half forward. Dunn in the front position. Couldn't quite hold onto the chest mark. Lockwood applying a bit of pressure. Illegal pressure, according to the umpire. And the free kick will go to Southport at half-back. Glenn Screech with the footy. Nice pass too. Found the target out there on the far side wing. Ben Merritt now with it. A little bit stop-start as they move it forward. Kick over the head of Veve. Probably looking for Josh Hunt there. Gets up to his feet. Gets the handball out of the pack. Just can't get a clean possession away here. Now Thunder through Cameron Islet. His handball just raked in by Dom Barry. Dom Barry gave it off to Bugler. Bugler slams it onto the boot and gets it up towards the centre of the ground. Bounces out towards the grandstand side wing. A little bit of a fumble there by Matthew Scully. Now the Sharks good enough, a little bit of time. And the kick up towards the wing marked by Harrison Fraser. Now they're finding a little bit of the football. James Holland takes a mark. He goes with the pass towards the attacking 50. He hits the teammate on the chest. So they've got a 55 out from goal. Called to play on Dylan Troutman. Troutman now from 45 metres out. Goes in towards goal.
Yeah,
can the Troutman catch one?
Great goal.
He has. Southport have got their first. One straight goal, six. Thunder, one goal, 2-8. It's really the first time they've threatened inside the attacking 50, Gilly.
It is, and the thing about it was is VV was actually on the mark stand, and he actually overran it. And look, I hate to say it, but that's schoolboy sort of stuff. And, you know, at this level, you shouldn't see that. He should have stood his ground, either blocked the player, made him kick over the hand. But anyway, he'll learn from that. And, you know, in terms of Thunder dominating, well, they're only 2 points up. But, look, good goal by the Southport Sharks.
Almost 10 minutes gone. Opening term, a 2-point lead to NT Thunder. Veve back in the ruck, and he just jumped straight into the opposing ruckman there, big Kieran Brennan. Now Matt Rosier with his nose over the football. Always low to the ground, Rosier. Tamling comes out of the pack with it. The umpire, well, everyone's
playing on
for a while. Play on, they said. And now Tamling kicks looking for Lockwood. A little bit of a nudge from behind, and the umpire's called it a free kick. It goes against Luke Hill. So big Lockwood can shoot for goal from right on 50 when he kicks this. Maybe a metre just inside.
Yeah, that Hill and Lockwood, that's going to be a battle for the ages for tonight's stand. There's no doubt about it, because I reckon that contest could actually determine who's going to win this game. That's how crucial it is, because Lockwood, you know, he can play up the ground, but also he can play inside his 50. And if you can get him inside his forward 50, he's got more chance of kicking goals.
So the big fella, Julian Lockwood, steps just inside that 50-metre line. This won't be a goal. Just fades out to the right. And 1 point on the board to Thunder. Four scoring shots they've got, but they only lead by 3 points. 1 goal, 3-9. Southport, 1 straight goal, 6. I guess that's been it, Gilly. Most of the kicks have come from that 50-metre range, haven't
they? Absolutely. And sometimes you just need to sit it in the goal square. You know, they'll work that out. There's no doubt. And I'm sure ex-Clark, the coach, will tell them at quarter time.
So Southport, they've got the footy on the half-back flank. Most of the play's been over this grandstand side of the ground. A little short pass forward has been marked by Jason Burge. Burge will also go short. Accurate with the kick again. Harrison Fraser with it now, longer and deep inside the attacking 50. Good use of the body. Play on, the whistle went. Southport about to run into goal, but the free kick's going to go to Thunder. Justin Emery will get the free kick. He went to ground in the marking contest. Sometimes they get away with it, sometimes they don't.
Yeah, look, wasn't a lot in it, Stan, but I suppose technically it was. But, look, I think probably let it go. But if they would have, they would have got a goal anyway.
Yeah, Rob Clements was running into the open goal. I'll send it back inside the attacking 50 here, the Sharks. It's not a bad short pass, and Josh Hunt's got it, and we know the distance, not a problem for him.
Yeah. Look, you know what? It's great to see Josh Hunt contributing to some form of football in another state, because obviously he's played at Geelong in a premiership, he went to GWS, and, you know, for him to move up to Brisbane, it's great to see it, because people like that, they promote our game, mate, and they give other people experience, and I'm sure he'll be teaching a lot of the Southport kids. The system coming through, he will help that club out, no doubt.
Yeah, thrill for the young players out there rubbing shoulders with him.
To be able to play with a premiership player, not many blokes can do that, Stan.
He's got a lovely left boot on him, hasn't he? And he's had no problems putting that one through. And all of a sudden, Southport have taken the lead. 2 straight goals, 12. NT Thunder, 1 goal, 3-9. 13 minutes gone, opening term. And you've said it, Gilbert. Thunder have been dominating all over the ground. 2 forward 50 entries, I reckon, for Southport. 2 goals.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, that's quality. You know, it's not about quantity. It's about making use of what you've got, and, you know, making sure that you use it, because it doesn't matter how many times you get it, you've got to score at the end of the day. So they're in front, stand by 3 points. Unbelievable.
Yeah, it is. It just doesn't seem like it's been panning out that way. I've been calling Thunder names, getting possessions all over the place. They've made the most of it, the Sharks. Pretty even contest in the middle here. Little handball came out of the pack. Dylan Mutu it was, and now the quick kick forward. They get it inside. They're attacking 50 again. It's been about 100% strike rate every time they've done it so far. Player went to ground there. Jack Anthony, another player with AFL experience for Collingwood and Fremantle. Bugler working hard just to try and lock it up here in the back pocket for NT Thunder, and the umpire will call for a ball up. We're only about 20 metres out from the Southport goal, and suddenly the Sharks have come to life.
Yeah. You look at the Territory Thunder. Well, there's no one in Territory Thunder from centre upwards now, so it's the tide's turn. Isn't it interesting, Stan?
The boot's on the other foot. Josh Hunt trying to use his strength. Gets the footy again.
Brennan.
Now the little kick forward. Chance here for Southport. The handball comes out to the big fella. He slammed it on the boot. Christian Bock. It goes right across the face. About 40 metres out from their goal. Still an opportunity here for Southport. See, that's a pretty good looking left footed snap around the body. Hits the post there. Good effort, Stephen Tyne. First minor score on the board for Southport. Almost their third goal.
It's interesting, Stan, what sort of an effect the game will have in terms of Territory Thunder leaving Darwin late. Will it have an effect on them? Because the Southport guys have been more relaxed, so I'm really interested to see how it pans out.
Yeah, they would have been there as the early team if it had gone ahead as scheduled, but in the end, it's Southport that have got here and had an extra couple of hours rest in Alice.
Yeah, but the thing about the NT Thunder guys, they had to get up so early in the morning.
They're already at the airport.
Exactly, and sometimes that's not a good thing. But look, we'll just see what happens. They're professional, or semi-professional, I should say. So I'm sure they'll, ex-Clark, you know, he's been there, done it. I'm sure he'll explain it to them.
There's the AFL experience for both sides again, too, in the coaching ranks, even Nathan Bock and Xavier Clark.
Oh, isn't it great to Southport Shark to have a bloke like Nathan Bock, you know, Adelaide Crows, and, you know, he's been a great player in that AFL level, no doubt about that.
Well, the Sharks have got the footy, but they're heading in the wrong direction as far as getting it towards their goal. Eventually, Nicholas Crowley gets it onto the boot and sends it up towards the wing. Cameron Islett collects it just inside the boundary line, but he can't keep it in play as big Christian Bock comes in to put on a little bit of pressure. Christian Bock, Nathan Bock, a little bit of a connection there, obviously. We're getting a nod of the head from the timekeeper.
Yeah.
Boundary throw in. He is a big one, isn't he, Bock?
Look at the size of it.
Free kick here. He's going to get it against Ryan Smith. Smith, and he played on with a little handball to Jared Brennan, but Brennan wasn't going anywhere. Thunder read that pretty well. Had to backtrack a bit, Brennan. Now the kick towards the half-forward flank. Crumb spilled to the front, taken by Darcy Trask. Little series of handballs here. Ben Merritt with it. He'll get the handball away, but he's missed Dylan Troutman. Troutman goes back to get the footy. Another handball off for the Sharks. 1-2 exchange there for Troutman. Getting involved in the middle of it was Jason Burge. Troutman's kick inside 50. Jack Anthony pulls in a one-hander. And he can go back and line up for goal from just inside 50.
Yeah, look, that was just a great mark. And don't you love, you know, you don't see it very often in football today, the one-on-one clashes. That was a perfect example, the old-fashioned one-on-one. Just let them go. Whoever gets the ball, that was a one-hander. That was brilliant, Mark. And, yeah, look, the distance you wouldn't think would be a worry, Stan. It's just a matter of his accuracy.
In pretty good form, too. Kicked 4 goals last week. So Jack Anthony, kick on its way. Goal umpire making a lot of ground to his left, and that's through 4-1 behind Southport. 2-2-14, NT Thunder 1-3-9. About 17 and a half minutes gone in the opening term. Talbot to bring the ball back into play for Thunder. He goes short to Justin Buglet. Took it in the back pocket. The umpire, I reckon, said not 15. Buglet under a bit of pressure. The handball to Chris Dunn. He's handballed to Talbot. He's also under pressure. And now Talbot with a kick. Back flank, but the Sharks have set up the wall there, and they're going to get a free kick in the marking contest. So a chance for Southport to get the footy deep back inside the attacking 50. It goes right to the hot spot, top of the goal square, off hands, inventive snap over the shoulder. Oh, that's a great goal.
That was class.
Terrific goal. Jared Brennan is the word we're getting from the timekeeper, and it was Brennan like, all right, that's the freakish skills he has. Terrific goal.
Yeah, well, we've seen an AFL player kick a goal from GWS a couple of weeks ago in Toby Green. He's done like a Maradona over the back, and that's exactly what Jared Brennan done. And, well, you know, we all know Jared's got freaky skills. There's no doubt about that.
He has. It's not the best goal I've seen from there, though, Gilly. We saw one day by Fabian Haynes for Tea Tree. We called the goal of the century, and I still haven't seen one better.
Well,
Brennan's was good.
And if you've called
not
it,
that good.
If you called a goal of the century, mate, I'm going to agree with you.
You were there. You did on the day.
I did.
Sammy Talbot gets the centre clearance kick here for Thunder, and the mark taken in the fingertips by young Michael Hagan. He's got some tricks too, young Hagan.
Yeah,
Played very well at the Nationals, at the under-18s.
Yeah, the son of Norm.
His pass to Lockwood is good. Lockwood from just outside 50, long to the goal square.
Patrick!
And Patrick takes a screamer.
Well,
the AFL players are giving us some highlights now. Jared Brennan's goal just 30 seconds ago, and now the large Amani lightning bolt. Liam Patrick leaps to the sky and pulls in a beauty.
Oh, look, mate, I've seen him do that at AFL level. I've seen him in AFL level take a mark like that, but I've also seen him kick goal of the year almost at that level. So for us to be able to witness this at Traeger Park, this is just magnificent. And I'll tell you what, if you wasn't getting excited before, well, you want it now, because that's almost a mark of the year in the NEAFL.
That's an absolute cracker. Shouldn't have any problems putting it through from here. He was slow to get to his feet from 5 metres out. Liam Patrick caps off a screamer of a mark with a goal for Thunder. Their second, 2-3-15. Southport still in front 3-2-20. A 5-point lead at the 20-minute mark of the opening term. Well, those last two highlights, Gilbert, absolutely superb.
Oh, look, people pay money to go and see those sorts of things. And well, Liam Patrick, he's an excitement machine, and he's got the X factor. That's what makes him so special. He can make something out of nothing, and that's exactly what he did then.
And a ripping game for Wanderers in the NTFL Grand Final this year as well. Led them to an upset win over St. Mary's. The umpire's going to recall that bounce in the centre of the ground. So we're engine time on now, red time. Couple of goals here for either side. Be very, very handy. Pretty even contest there between the two ruckmen. No one effective. Tambling knocked it out towards the wing. Now the big ruckman, Kieran Brennan for Southport, got his nose over the footy, but a quick kick forward off a boot of a Thunder player, and they get it towards the attacking 50. Glenn Screech has taken the mark for Southport. Goes out to the Todd River side of the ground. Didn't gain any yardage for Southport, just retaining possession.
Yeah, it's almost like they've said, all right, fellas, let's just settle it down a little bit now, because it was going up and down, you know, pretty hectic pace, Dan.
So footy up towards the wing. Sam Talbot applies a tackle. The ball knocked forward in Southport's direction. Big Kieran Brennan threw a good shepherd in there. Gave his teammate an opportunity and a little bit of space. The kick forward now for Southport up towards the attacking 50. Bugler got his nose over the football. Nice one-handed pick-up by Glenn Screech. Couldn't get an effective handball away, though. Aaron Motlop goes after the footy now for Thunder. He's been tackled, lost it. The umpire said holding the ball. So free kick will go to Southport. Glenn Screech to take it. He's about 65 metres out from goal. Ben Rioli over there caught with the footy, perhaps.
Yeah, no, well, it was good pressure, wasn't it? And that's what caused the turnover. But look, he's a fair bit outstanding.
Jared Brennan, in fact.
He just needs to put it to the goal square.
So Brennan bangs it towards the goal square. Jack Anthony jumping from behind, the ball off hands and over the boundary line. Boundary throw in right next to the behind post. Southport deep in attack, leading by 5 points. Just over 2 minutes of time on played, opening term. Veve in the front position for Thunder. Oh, Anthony, slick hands to Hunt. Hunt on the left.
Oh, how good was that?
Wait on the goal umpire here, but he's heading back towards the centre. So that's a goal. Another one for Southport. Hunt kicks a beauty. Southport 4 goals, 2-26. Thunder 2-3-15.
Oh, what a move by Coach Bock to put him in the forward line, because we know Hunt as a specialist backman, and he's normally stopping blokes from kicking the goals. He's kicked 2 goals where he's made something out of nothing. That's a skill. Great goal by him. Great move by Bock putting him in the forward line.
Yeah, even as a defender, always renowned for how good a kick he was. So,
kicking out.
Yep, so now that's been put to good use at the other end of the ground. If you're a good kick, kicking the footy in, still a good kick when you're lining up for goal, aren't
you? Well, I don't know about that, because fullbacks kick out, mate. They're not very good at kicking goals, I can guarantee you now. Just ask Danny Frawley, I know.
They would say they don't get enough opportunities.
Yeah.
Whistle's gone in the middle here, just as Southport was streaming forward. I think it's going to be a Thunder free kick. I reckon I've been picked out by the umpire that was well out of the action. Philip Wills will take the free kick here for Thunder.
No, well, that's what they're there for, Stan. And if they see an infringement, they're entitled to do that. So if he thinks they're infringement, he's allowed to blow the whistle.
Thomas Motlop kicks out wide. Jonathan Parris, oh, nice mark. Plucked it from behind his Southport opponent. They're leading everywhere inside the attacking 50. Goes towards the goal square. Ewing one-on-one wrestling contest. It actually cleared that. Patrick, a sucker!
Oh, he's done it again.
He's got another one. Second on the board for Liam Patrick. And the Lajamanu Lightning Boulders kept Thunder in it in the opening term. Couple of real highlights there. 3-3-21 Southport, 4-2-26.
Yeah, no, look, just when you thought Southport were getting on top, Hunt's kicked two, Patrick's kicked two, so game on, bring it on. It's back to 5 points now, and mate, we could be in for a good game tonight, Stan. You know, a long way to go, but gee, the way they've started off, they're having a go, they're not mucking around, they're attacking.
Entertaining opening quarter, and we've seen some real good highlights, and the AFL experienced players are turning it on. Josh Hunt, two goals, Jared Brennan, an absolute beauty, and now Liam Patrick a couple.
Oh, look, great stuff, and you know, they're the sort of people who will bring gates through Traeger Park. And that's what people should appreciate, those players, because come out and watch them. Come out and see them, because, and bring your kids and let the kids watch them.
Yeah, it's still plenty of class out there. The AFL days might be over, but they're turning it on at Traeger today. Free kick in the middle of the ground will go Southport's way. Tyler Cornish. He kicks it long and direct. Sam Talbot parks himself in front of Ranger Sleeper, coming from behind. Anthony's taken the mark, played on, slipped the handball out sideways. They'll have a ping at goal here from 45 out. And it hits the behind post on the full. Was it touched into it? It was. Yeah. We'll get a boundary throw in.
It's just going from goal to goal. This is great. Great to watch.
Good.
Yeah, great, great. If you're a spectator, you'd be enjoying this.
Ryan Smith got there late for the ruck contest. Trying to barge through Rob Clements. Couldn't take the footy with him. Now, a pack of players over the top of this, and the umpire will call for a ball up again. This time, the footy's 40 metres straight out from the Southport goal. They're leading by 5 points. Played almost 6 minutes of time on in the opening term, so probably not too far away from siren time. Some fierce tackling there by the Southport forwards. Always stayed on it a long time, and the umpire's pinged him holding the ball.
Yeah.
You know when you get that little pause, Gilbert, and we're just waiting and waiting.
You know they're going to do it, don't you?
Yep. Gee, right in front of the big sticks too.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Ah, look, if it's a free and it's warranted, no worries about that. But I reckon when you're inside the forward 50 and you're trying to kick a goal, I'm a big believer you've got to earn a free kick. But, you know, if it's there, it's there.
Glenn Screech from only 25, 30 metres directly out in front puts it through for Southport's fifth. Just before quarter time, they move their score on to 5-2, 32, NT Thunder, 3-3, 21. Gee, they've really played well since the opening 10 minutes, Southport, because Thunder were all over them in the first 10 minutes of the quarter, but they've responded in real good fashion.
Oh, mate, they've answered the call. There's no doubt about that. And the reason why I'm saying about that decision, Stan, is if they make a decision like that, that means they've got to do that up the other end, and they've got to stick with it, and they've got to be consistent. And if they do that, everyone's happy with it. So if he's going to pay that there, he's got to pay at both ends.
I reckon where we never see it is around the middle of the ground.
They never do it. They always seem to do it in the forward line. That's what I don't like.
When there's a goal on the line, footy back in the centre. And plenty of players in there after it at the moment. The umpire's going to call for another ball up. Right in the centre of Traeger Park, the centre of Australian football, as Cal Dean dubbed it.
Oh, magnificent.
It's on here, Cameron Eilert, and Southport opponent. Is a little bit off, further off the pack as well. Jonathan Perrist involved with his opponent.
Gee.
Just testing out what material the jumpers are made of. Is it a fine Australian wool product or is it synthetic, I think?
Eilert's a player you've got to watch. And he'll be a player that Southport are watching, because Eilert can win the game. And he's a player that normally gets tagged. I think he's come off with the blood rule.
Yeah, there's a blood rule here. There's a bit going on. There's still a bit of push and shove off the footy around centre forward here for Southport.
No, it's good stuff. It's good to see a bit of that old stuff happening every now and then. It's nothing nasty. They're just being boys. That's all they are.
Sorted out. We haven't seen any punches.
No, there's no need for them. You just push and shove. You know what it's like. It's just standing your grandstand. That's what it is.
Tyler Cornish kicks it long, deep inside 50. Looking for Anthony again.
Yeah,
Mark's
paid.
Is he going to get a free kick?
No, it was a mark. Great mark.
Justin Bugler. Short pass out wide. Gets it to Philip Wills deep in the back pocket now for Thunder. The long kick from him towards the wing. Cleared the marking contest. Rosier leads in the race for the footy. Good body work to get rid of his opponent. Or the bounce didn't quite come back to him. He has to wait to pick it up. The little handball off now to Cameron Eilert. Eilert's kick will bounce inside the attacking 50. Michael Hagen there can't get away from his opponent. Holding the ball, is it?
Oh.
Free kick's going to go Southport on the defensive 50.
Oh, it was pretty quick, wasn't it? It was a great tackle, don't get me wrong.
Pretty slick one.
But, you know, I mean, what else could he have done then? It was just a great tackle and a great contest. Just play on.
Couldn't get tackled by a stronger one, could he, Josh Hunt? This one for the youngster. Pass from Hunt's been marked by Robert Blood off their rookie list. Young Blood. towards centre-half back is good.
Dangerous.
Well, the next one to the wing was dangerous, wasn't it? Thunder players everywhere, and another free kick picked out. And it's going Southport's way. A few things going their way. Darcy Trask with the footy.
Yeah, not a lot in it.
He's going to come out very, very wide. Gibson Turner after a bright start we haven't seen very much of. A couple of possessions early on.
No, that's because Southport have controlled the game in the last 10 to 12 minutes. They've dominated, no doubt about that.
Dylan Troutman goes long and deep inside the attacking 50 again. Too dear, they had some fair old hands on that. Some slick handball too. Harrison Fraser unable to get through the traffic, holding the ball in favour of Thunder this time. They've got the free kick deep in the back pocket. Might be Eldridge back there with the football. A short pass from him to Sam Talbot. Justin Emery. Emery on the defensive 50 now for Thunder. The leads are offered short, two of them, Rosier and Tambling. He goes for Tambling. Now Tambling's got it. At least they've got it outside the defensive 50. He's only a couple of metres in from the boundary line. He kicks now towards the wing looking for big Julian Lockwood. A little bit of wrestling in that marking contest.
Oh, great handball.
Terrific handball. Brennan it was. And now the kick inside 50 for Southport. G. Anthony, good hands on it. Couldn't complete the mark. There's a good tackle. Oh, no. In the back. The umpire calls it. So the free kick will go to Southport. 55 out from goal, Jack Anthony.
Yeah, well, look, he actually fell over. And, I mean, I know technically it's there. But, I mean, I honestly believe it's play on. But anyway, the umpires called it, and this is a great opportunity for them to kick another goal because they'll go three goals up at quarter time, Stan, because Soren is going to blow very, very soon, and this will be a handy goal for them.
We've had about 11 minutes of time on as Jack Anthony from 52 metres out got underneath it. Yeah, just couldn't quite get the distance on it. There, Vey there to tap it over the line. So quarter time, Southport leading NT Thunder. 5 goals to 32 to 3-3-21. We probably didn't think it was going to pan out that way, Gilbert. So the first 10 minutes was all Thunder. Great comeback by Southport.
Oh, look, great game of footy to watch. The first quarter has been brilliant. And the way the Territory Thunder guys started, obviously this is their home ground. And, you know, we've spoken about their interrupted travel. You know, the game's been delayed. So it's important for people to know this because that can have an effect on the players. And the way they started, it was like, oh, yeah, they probably said, yeah, let's have a good start just to let them know that this hasn't worried us. All of a sudden, after 10 to 12 minutes, Southport started to take control. More importantly, they started to kick goals. And more importantly, they put scoreboard pressure on them. And that's what they've done now. And, well, they're 2 goals up.
The other goal kickers at the first break. Firstly for Southport, Josh Hunt with 2 and 1 each for Glenn Screech, Jared Brennan and Dylan Troutman. And for NT Thunder, 2 goals to Liam Patrick and 1 to Darren Ewing. Couple of highlights. Great goal, Jared Brennan, and an absolute screamer by Liam Patrick. We'll take a short break from the commentary during quarter time proceedings and be back very, very soon with the second term. Don't go anywhere.
Yeah.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for NT Thunder.
And welcome back to our coverage of the Round 18 NEAFL match between NT Thunder and the Southport Sharks. It's being played in Alice Springs at Traeger Park, the centre of Australian football, and at quarter time at Southport, 5-2-32. 11-point lead over Thunder, 3-3-21. My name's Dan Coombe. Joining me in commentary, former Alice Springs football legend, Gilbert McAdam, great to be back, and what a great opening term of footy that was. Exciting football from both teams.
Oh, it's absolutely brilliant, and like I said, the conditions are magnificent, but I'll tell you one thing, this town hasn't lost. Pretty cold, brother, that cold wind. That's one thing I don't miss. I can believe you now. I'd rather think I'd be back in Melbourne.
People that don't come from a desert just don't understand how cold it can actually get in one, do
well,
they?
Well, I told someone the other day it was -1, and they said, what, in Alice Springs? You're kidding. I said, mate, -1.
Yeah. There was snow last year, or earlier this year.
In Alice Springs?
A bit of snow out El Papa way.
Well, I'll be damned.
Yeah, that's what we all said. Here go Thunder. Don Barry gets the handball forward to Michael Hagan. He's got it just outside the attacking 50. Kicks looking for Ewing on the lead into the pocket. Gee, good defensive play there by the Southport defender. He's making life hard for Ewing at the moment. Nice little handball out by Dylan Troutman. He's had a bit of the footy. The kick comes towards the halfback flank for Southport. Bounces out of bounds. We'll get a boundary throw in.
Yeah, just looking at all around the grandstand, every player one-on-one. There's no zones or there's no extra man, you know. Everyone's accountable for everyone, and that's what I love to see.
Yeah, I like that. It's a bit more of the old-style footy. Ryan Smith tried to get a handball away. Ball socket off the ground by Tyler Cornish for Southport. Ben Rioli's got it on the wing. They managed to wrap him up. Rosier goes in and applies attack. Oh, he's a terrier, isn't he? Now he's got the footy. Thrown to the ground like a rag doll. Now Islet comes in and tackles his opponent to ground and will get a ball up right on centre wing.
Yeah, both. You can see it. You can see
it's a bit of feeling.
I reckon the coaches, what they said at quarter time, something's happened, because since they've come out in the second quarter, Stan, there's feeling. You can feel it.
You don't see Cameron Island getting involved in this sort of stuff very often. Now, Thomas Motlop got a clearing kick forward. I think there was a whistle and then advantage given to Thunder. Now Gibson Turner picks up the footy, spears the pass low and hits Julian Lockwood on the chest, 45 metres out from goal. He's had the footy three times, Gibson Turner, and he's drilled that pass every single time.
Yeah, look, he's great skill, doesn't he, you know, and that's his value. When he gets possession, it's quality. It's, you know, he doesn't waste it.
Big Julian Lockwood had a kick from about this range in the first quarter.
Yeah.
He got the distance, but it faded out to the right.
This will really test him.
There is no breeze out there. A still night in Alice Springs. Julian Lockwood on his way in. He didn't give himself much of a run up right on 50. He's hit it pretty nicely. It'll go to the line and touched through, I think. Conference here between the boundary, goal, field umpire. They're coming from all directions, the men in fluoro green.
I don't think we've got the third camera, have we, in Alice Springs? Have we, or what?
They'll come to Gilbert McAdam upstairs.
Well, I've never seen it done in Alice Springs before.
Point. Oh, meanwhile, one of the boundary umpires has taken a bit of a tumble while running backwards away from the action.
But you know what, Stan? I like that because what if there was 30 seconds to go and there was a crucial kick that won the game for them? So it's important for them to consult each other.
As long as they've got it right. Gee, that was a raking kick in by Josh Hunt. That was reminiscent of his days at Geelong. And with the second kick, they've got the footy all the way to the half-forward flank. Leading in the race for it, though, Ben Rioli gives a little handball backwards. Now Thunder, still mucking around with the handball. Paris went backwards to Rioli. Rioli short kick. I think he's looking for Nias there. It's come unstuck. Little handball forward gets into the attacking 50 for Southport. Their player dragged off the footy. He didn't have it. So they've got the free kick. Be just a bit too far out to score. The handball off to Jared Brennan. Brennan from 60 out goes into the goal square. Anthony gets rid of one opponent.
Oh, what a mark.
And then takes a mark. Threw Bugler to the ground. Then took on another opponent and grabbed it. Now he'll go for the pass. I think the umpire might bring it back.
Son, if you take a mark, you never kick it. You go for goal, son.
Yeah.
Don't pass it off.
It's pretty hard to get them.
Yeah, I mean, I know he's on a difficult angle, but go back and back yourself.
It's your name in the paper, mate.
Well.
Jack Anthony. Well, he wants to do one of these sort of Stevie Johnson type kicks around the corner. Whatever happened to the drop punt?
No. It's the modern day footballer today. They all do it. They all... Oh, well, he's not. He's actually... He must have heard you because he's gone back and he's gone with the...
I'd rather
with the traditional drop punt.
Greatest kicker of all time, Tony Plugger Lockett, never had to do it, did he?
Never seen him do it once.
Drop punt. If that's
around the corner, I mean. Yep. Apart from 60 metres out and it still went through.
Anthony, you should have kicked around the corner. He's missed with the drop punt. 1 point. There you go. No, look, I'd just prefer to see it, Gilbert. I reckon that's the kick you grow up learning how to do.
Yeah.
Why not?
Nah, they don't do things like normal, like we used to do, mate. Everything's all different these days.
I reckon it's created an excuse to miss, making it look a bit harder than it really is. Ewing now at centre-half, full on his own. He's going to get a free kick. It's been a few whistles go with the marking contest so far.
Well, there's been a few whistles blowing, and I don't like listening to a lot of whistles blowing. I just like to let them play. Let them play football. Let them earn the free kicks. Let them... have a contest. Let him work hard to get it.
Oh, fair old pass by Darren Ewing. He's hit Chris Dunn on the chest. And the Southport defence had a lot of time to man up then. And Ewing just waited and waited and drilled a low one. Now Dunn to shoot for goal from 45 out.
Yeah, it's amazing, these two guys. You know, key forwards. They always compensate each other. But, you know, more importantly, they look for each other. And look at that perfect pass.
Wouldn't mind looking up the stats on the amount of times they're both in a game kick five apiece. Or something along those lines. It's happened on a regular basis now. Chris Dunn, yet to get one on the board so far this evening. That looks pretty good off the boot. He's got one on the board now, and Thunder get the first goal of the second term, and they creep a little bit closer, moving on to 4-4-28. Back within 5 points of Southport, 5-3-33. 6 minutes gone, second term.
Ah, look, great goal by them, and well done. You know, the key forwards combining and... They actually started it off from defence then when they turned that ball over, Stan. So that's a good sign. Game on. Back to, 5 points, are we?
Yep, less than a kick in it.
Just quickly, too, Stan, for our people that are watching. Tyler Cornish, he's got the job on Islet. So every time Islet, he's on off the ground at the moment. But when he comes on, I'll guarantee you, Tyler will be on him.
He's not doing a bad job either because Islet...
Hasn't had a lot of it.
Not as prolific possession-wise as he normally is. Philip Wills, gee, that was a slick little handball out of the middle. And a nice little kick too over the top to Dominic Barry from Jonathan Perris. Barry kicks towards Ewing. It hit him in the head beautifully. Crumb Michael Hagen in towards goal. Oh, it just goes across the face. Southport defender got a fist on it, sent it through four behind. It's under 4-5-29. Southport 5-3-33. The short kick in has been marked by Josh Hunt. And then that low raking left foot kick of his towards centre half back. It's a beauty, and the mark taken by Kieran Brennan. So the big ruckman, he'll give it back to Josh Hunt. Forced to stop on his run there. Now the handball back to Brennan, and another handball. This one over to Jason Burge, and Burge kicks up towards the wing area. Jonathan
Parrish
gets the footy for Thunder. Sends it forward. Tim Eldridge might be able to run onto this. Waits, leaves it for his teammate, Aaron Motlop. Now the handball over to Eldridge. Eldridge from deep in the forward pocket. Centres it up, looking for Liam Patrick. Went over his head, though. Lurking at the back here, Michael Hagen. Collecting the footy, though. Matthew Scully, though, for the Sharks. Got it away to a teammate. Now long clearing kick. Sends it back towards R4G. Ben Rioli nudged out of that marking contest. He'll get a free kick on the half-back flank for NT Thunder.
Yeah, Eldridge, you know, that was the right idea. That was, I can see what he was going to do, but there was three Southport ones. He's probably better off just putting it in the square.
I would have went for home myself.
Yeah, true, that's true. We would have done that.
Thomas Motlop with the kick inside the defensive 50 to Justin Bugler, and now Bugler goes long out towards the wing. Nehus up in the marking contest. The crumbs are beautifully gathered by Thomas Tyne for Southport. Now
great
the kick goes
what
to Anthony, who marks at the top of the goal square. The kick forward there by Dylan Troutman. He's having a good game, and Jack Anthony looking dangerous up forward. Hasn't got a goal alongside his name yet, but he's taken a few grabs inside 50.
Yeah, and he's making a contest, and that's what the coach wants for a forward, to be able to make a contest, and if he doesn't make the contest, bring it to ground and get the other players involved. And look, he's had a lot of the ball. There's no doubt about that. He's got to kick goals now because he needs to put scoreboard pressure on him.
Pretty casual approach, but why not from 15 metres out directly in front? Jack Anthony has got a goal on the board now. He's first, and Southport get their first in the second term. They move their score on to 6-3-39, 10-point leaders over NT Thunder, 4-5-29. 9 minutes gone, second term. One goal apiece so far in this term, and it's continued on just like the first. Good, entertaining footy.
Oh, look, absolutely. And, you know, you just think, when you think... Thunder's coming back, Southport answer, you know, and that's what makes it so interesting. And don't go away, because we're going to see more of this. This is great. This is great to watch.
So Ryan Smith to do the ruckwork for NT Thunder. Well, they stopped and had a look at each other there, and then Ryan Smith plucked it out of the air, got a handball away to Philip Wills. He looked like he copped one in the back of the head as he got the handball away. Still down on his haunches, Philip Wills, and feeling the noggin as the umpire calls for a ball up. Footy still in the centre of the ground.
Yeah, great acquisition, Philip Wills, has been for Territory Thunder. I coached him at Buffaloes when I coached him, and, mate, he was only a 16-year-old kid, and he was playing senior. He's very, very mature.
So footy in the centre again. They dive in over the top, and again the umpire will call for a ball up. Just a little lull in proceedings. It's the first time I reckon we've had consecutive balls up in the centre like that. It's been free-flowing football most of the time. Eldridge weaves its way through traffic. That was brilliant. Kick didn't hit the boot real well. It helicoptered its way towards the attacking 50. Eldridge backing up. Gets a soccer on it. Sends it a little bit further forward, but out wide, and it goes over the boundary lines. He's got electric pace.
He has, and he's had a bit of excitement to them, you know. And, you know, when you see him and, like, a Benny Rioli, you know, he's got pretty quick pace, you know. Them sort of blokes can turn it on, especially late in the game, stand when everyone else is getting tired.
Territory football built on pace, too.
Exactly.
Eldridge getting busy out there, got his hands on the footy again.
I watched him a couple of weeks ago, Stan, and they saved him for the second half. And ex-Clark, it was a great move by Xavier, and you could see what he was doing. He saved him, and you know what? He was one of the reasons why they got up and beat Aspley a couple of weeks ago.
That sort of pace, with a bit of freshness late in the game, that would run through.
You can't beat it.
Now, Southport, kick away towards the wing. Ben Rioli couldn't take that. Neither could Cameron Islet. Big pack around this. Oh, some strong tackling. They're able to break through here. Three of those. The Sharks, oh, just the kick away before the tackle arrived. Anthony, strong hands again. Just couldn't quite complete the mark. Second grab. Good defence by Bugler. Ryan Smith gets the footy now. The big Thunder ruckman. Hamill didn't quite hit Jonathan Paris. Paris a soccer off the ground now. Aaron Motlop hooks a kick around the body. Bounces it forward of centre. The footy taken for the Sharks, though, by Nicholas Crowley. He'll deliver to a teammate out wide. They're linking up with handball out there now. Jason Burge. Burge just gets the kick away and finds the big ruckman. I think it's Kieran Brennan with the footy and a 50-metre penalty.
Well,
someone just step across the mark there, I'm assuming.
No, I could see the umpire blowing the whistle to get him back, but it was very, very, very technical, very technical. But anyway, that's their job. That's what they do. He's paid it.
Brock plays on, gave a handball off to Matthew Scully. Scully goes long in towards goal. Bugler just
great.
Gets a fingertip on it.
Lucky.
It was
going through, Stan.
So big Justin Bugler. Short kick into the back pocket. Ben Rioli's taken the mark. Richard Tamling wants it short. The kick goes in that direction. Tamling marks it just inside the boundary line. Hasn't been as prominent in the second term as he was in the first. Tamling long, looking for the ruckman, Ryan Smith. Good battle against big Brock. Brock had the better of it, just couldn't quite complete the mark. Stripped of the footy there, Tyler Cornish. Pack of players over the top, and the umpire taking a long time.
Yeah.
When he does that, we're going to holding the ball.
We know exactly what they're going to do. We know, Stan.
Just when you were about to say you'll ball it up and it doesn't happen, that's when you know you've got a free kick coming. So Ryan Smith. Oop, played on with a little handball, and they
that's dangerous.
Luckily, the cool-headed Tamling there to back up. He's kicked it out to Bugler, and the big fella's away. Big Bugler blowing his own trumpet out there on the Todd Riverside wing. Two bounces from the big fella. Low trajectory kick out in front of Liam Patrick. He can't get to it. Southport linking up. Matthew Scully took the handball, got the kick away into the centre square and found Thomas Tyne. Tyne plays on, gets around one. From the centre circle, he kicks to the half forward flank, playing in the front position. Good effort by the Thunder defender. Sam Talbot's taken the mark, and now he'll play on with a kick out to Gibson Turner, who marks centre wing grandstand side. Turner's off, goes long, deep inside 50. Ewing coming from behind. Oh, in front, Hagen. Oh, and the free kick is going to go to the Sharks, is it? It is. Thought Hagen was maybe a little bit of a chance to kick his first at Traeger.
Yeah. I've got to stop saying what I'm saying. Let's just play on. Let's play footy.
So the Sharks, a couple of loose players on the defensive 50. The mark's been taken by Stephen Tyne. Now they work their way through the middle of the ground. Jason Burge ends up with it. Kick towards half forward flank, couple of high flyers there. Jared Brennan up, couldn't take the mark, running away with the footy. Ben Rioli kicks into the centre of the ground. No one home there though for Thunder. Robert Blood leads in the race for the footy for the Sharks. Good effort by young Hagen to home, hold him up momentarily. Blood had assistance. His handball intercepted by Rioli. Handball off to Dom Barry, and now Dom Barry's away. Two bounces, gets to the half forward flank, draws the player. Handball over the top to Rozier. Rozier looking for Turno. Oh, went up and down. Didn't get near the footy. It rolls out of the boundary line, and the umpire, who wasn't close to it, is going to pay a free kick.
Well, the umpire from 60 metres has paid that, and yet the umpire was 2 metres away, and he's caught play on.
Oh, Rozier intercepts.
I can't work that out.
Rozier intercepted the kick out of defence, pumps it back looking for Ewing, who marks it 5 metres out from goal. Oh, chance to get away with that, Southport, and gee, the kick out of defence wasn't good. Rozier getting busy, and now Ewing. He should be kicking this. He is on a tightish angle, but he should be kicking this from just 5 metres out.
Yeah, well, it was probably a bit of justice there, I suppose, because I couldn't work that one out. So, anyway, he's got a chance to kick a goal here.
Oh, he goes with the right boot, Ewing, and he's hooked it too far.
That's the TVJ. Go back and just kick it straight, son. But anyway, he does it all the time. So we can't criticise him for doing it because he does it all the time, and normally he kicks it. He didn't kick at that time.
Can't fold his goal kicking over the years, can we? Southport 6-4, Thunder 4-6. 10 points the lead to Southport. Almost 16 minutes gone in the second term as Southport moved the ball out of defence down the Todd River side of the ground. Gee, Jack Anthony leading a long way out of the forward area there to take the mark on the back flank.
I've been impressed with him, Stan, because even though he hasn't kicked a lot of many goals, he's been a target, and that's what you want.
He's taken a lot of marks. And he's covering a bit of territory as well. Now they come back to the grandstand side of the ground, Southport. Chris crossing their way up Traeger Park. Gee, Josh Hunt had good purchase on that. Mark not paid, though.
Nah, 2-on-1 then, and that was well done by Motlop and Gibson Turner then. Just to, you know, you don't want him to take a mark then, because then they can chance to set up, whereas now it's a throw-in, gives them an opportunity. Thunder now.
Beautifully rode by Dominic Barry. Gets the handball away over to Justin Emery.
Oh, great
good
pressure.
Tackle it was.
Great pressure.
Don't know about holding the ball because he dropped it onto his boot.
It should have just
been. But it was a terrific tackle nonetheless, Tyler Cornish.
Well, he tried to kick it, so it should have been play on. But no, look, is it a prior opportunity? That's the big question. So, fair call.
Great tackle, Tyler Cornish. Gets the kick out towards the wing. They had a couple of flyers in the front position. Islet knocked the ball out of an opponent's hands. Josh Hunt, desperate at the bottom of the pack, got it out. A little kick scrub forward, too. It was effective there. And Ben Merritt kicks it further forward. It was Harrison Fraser doing the good work on the boundary line. There's Anthony again with the footy, 55 out from goal.
And they love blowing the whistle, these guys. They love blowing the whistle.
Well, the mark's
just let
way back
just let
where
the game,
he is.
Just let the game play.
Anthony rubbing the head. So he's definitely cop one.
Let the players dictate the game, not the umpires. Just let them play.
So Thunder's defenders have had plenty of time to block up the defensive 50. Anthony goes the short pass out into the pocket. He was looking for Jared Brennan. Went up and down, didn't get a hand near the footy there. The ball ends up rolling out of bounds in the snake pit pocket.
Snake, that's, I've played on this ground for so many years and I've never heard that saying.
Yeah, the old Rovers snake pit, when Rovers used to have the clubhouse over where the cricket development office.
Now I know where you're coming from.
Richard Tamling picks up the footy just inside the boundary line for Thunder. Hooks the left-footed kick around the body back towards the half-back flank. Thomas Motlop picked it up, but he was dispossessed and they slung him. Hung on to him too long, so he's going to get a free kick. There has been a lot of whistles, Gilly.
Yeah, too much. Just let him play.
So Thomas Motlop thought about a short one out wide to Dom Barry on the wing. He's changed his mind about that. And now he'll go long. Still kept it out wide. Liam Patrick to jump from. Well, he didn't get a jump at it in the end. And Kieran Brennan, big fella in the front position, has taken the mark.
I don't think even if he jumped, because Brennan's about 3 metres tall, he would have took mark of the century.
201 centimetres, according to my information. Now, Eldridge gets the crumbs after the marking contest. All squared that up. It's dangerous. Dunn was good. Crumbs gathered by Hagen.
Oh, well done.
His handball intercepted. It came back to Hagen, though. Hagen with some poise. Kicks inside 50, looking for Ewing. Oh, thought he had hold of his hand. The umpire agrees. Free kick to Darren Ewing. And he can shoot for goal from right on 50.
Yeah, look, the only good thing about it is they're giving frees to both sides, and that's okay if it's consistent. Otherwise, don't blow it at all. Let them earn it.
So Ewing, he's kicked one. Missed one from close range earlier on in this term. Got his goal in the opening term. He's had reasonable success here at Traeger Park over the years. He's had a few handy goal hauls.
If you look at being a stalwart for the Territory Thunder, he's probably been one of their greatest players in the history of the Territory Thunder. That's how much you got to rate him.
Oh, look at that kick. He snuck that inside the post and hugged the line the whole
great goal,
way.
Wasn't it?
Looked like it was going to hit the post and just curled inside. Ewing's got his second.
Yeah, great kick, wasn't it?
Well, that's why he's kicked so many. Leading goal kicker a few times. He's kicked 100 in this competition before in a season.
And like I said, if you're talking about stalwarts and blokes that's done stuff for Territory Thunder, mate, he's got to be right up there.
There's a couple of fellas that have had good careers with Thunder, and you think, gee, they're a bit unlucky not to get an AFL game or two. Ewing one, Cameron Island would be another. Mm. Ben Rioli.
I can see why.
Just missed out, haven't they?
Well, you look at Ewing, you know, he's probably...
position player.
Well, he's not tall enough to be that key position player, but he's not quick enough to be that forward flanking player. And, well, you know, I don't want to judge people too much, but...
great NEAFL career, you know. Nonetheless. So it's back to a four-point game. Southport 6-4-40, Thunder 5-6-36. Mad scramble for this one in the centre of the ground. The umpire will call for a ball up.
But you know what I love about it, Stan, is that you don't have to play AFL. You don't have to be at the elite level. You can play at this level and still contribute to the great game, but not only the great game, but to the state and the people back home. That's what you can do.
You've certainly got yourself to play at the highest level that's become available to you. You've got to strive for that.
Exactly.
So there's a mark on the half-back flank for NT Thunder, taken by Justin Emery.
You know, it's like these community players that come into Alice Springs and they end up eventually play for the local towns. Mate, it's a big thing for them. It's a big thing for them.
Yeah, but then we get our country rep side and they love that too. It's another step again.
Well, they want to beat the city boys. That's what it's all about.
The footy on the wing, grandstand side of the ground. Philip Wills getting in the action with the tackle. The umpire will have a ball up.
Interesting too, Stanley, I should have said before, both clubs are changing.
Yeah, the
they're rotating,
heavy,
so they realise and understand that, you know, this is going to be good for later in the game.
Jeez, tough in the clinches here out on the wing. Eventually, Thunder get the clearance. Chris Dunn slammed it onto the boot. Wasn't effective though, straight to the opposition. Matthew Scully's got the mark at half back for the Southport Sharks. Hunt wanted it short. Hunt still wants it short. Oh, he's playing on there, a little bit of strife here.
Oh, great handball, wasn't it?
Yeah, licked up with Luke Hill in the 1-2. Now the short pass, here's Anthony again. He just keeps presenting, doesn't he? Another mark. His kick will go inside 50. Clash of bodies. The ball over the head of the marking contest spills out into the forward pocket, leading in the race for it there. Thomas Tyne for Southport couldn't take it. Little handball comes out to Tamling. Tamling got a handball back off and receives it again. Might be Chris Dunn doing some work back there in defence. Then Jonathan Paris back to Tamling again. Tamling now kicks towards the wing from behind. Gibson Turner went the fist. Disciplined stuff. Lockwood gets the crumbs. Under a bit of pressure, he's coughed up the handball. It's gone to the opposition. Brushing off the tackle there, Tyler Corn. It's the handball to Josh Hunt. Sold a bit of candy. Gets the handball off to Blake Erickson. Erickson's kick hugging the boundary line has been marked by Thomas Tyne. They're still 65 metres out from goal. Gee, good hectic passage of play from both sides.
And you know what I love about it? No one's scoring goals, so it's just going bang, bang, end, side, side. Great footy, great to watch.
Don't necessarily need goals to be entertained, do you?
No, you don't. No way.
Emery working hard in defence. Long kick. Patrick bumped out of it, standing his ground. Oh, the umpire saw the bump. He's called it an illegal shepherd. I saw it, I called it.
Yeah, good call, Stanley.
Meantime, Wade Mills has taken the mark, but he's not going to get the footy. Liam Patrick will. They're lining up for him across half-back. Short pass over to Ryan Nears. Nears will switch it right out to the Todd River side of the ground. Gee, Chris Dunn's starting to cover some territory now. He was just back down deep inside the attacking 50 earlier. Back to Nears. Inside the centre square. Wide now. Back out to the wing to Dominic Barry. So just working their way forward this time, Thunder.
Good to see two local Red Tails players, I suppose, in Barry and
Gibbo Turner. Gibbo playing for him as well. Long kick towards the wing. Yeah, we like to see a few locals when they come to Alice Springs, at least, mate.
Of course we do. And if we don't, the locals won't like it. So we've got to see our brothers and our family. We've got to see them in there.
We're going to toss Matty Razor in. Of course, he's moved up to Darwin these days too. So the ball on that Todd Riverside wing, and Southport trying to move it forward here. Big Wade Mills ducked his head into the pack. The other big fella over there too getting into it, Christian Brock. And eventually Tamlin comes away with the footy. Out to Dom Barry. We were just talking about him. Another possession. Had a run, one bounce, then stop, prop. Short pass forward. Another Centralian there. There's Matty Razor. Matt the Desert Rat Razor.
Well, that's what the Darwin guys used to call us. They used to call us desert rats, and we used to call them swamp rats.
Cheaters.
Well, that's how we spoke to each other. But you know what? When it became territory, we were all brothers. We were all one.
Spirit time.
Tamling, that's right.
Tamling picking up some possessions late in this second term. Short pass to Chris Dunn now. He's got it about 60 out from goal, too far out to score. Centres it up towards the hot spot. Top of the goal square. Lockwood. Crumbs taken by Gibson Turner. The twister through the traffic.
What a goal.
The great goal, Gibson Turner.
That's class.
Thunder have taken the lead. Well, the locals like that. Finding a bit of voice. They know it's one of their own who's kicked it. Gee, through some traffic too. There was players everywhere coming at him. The twister, he does know how to do it. He twists and turns his way out of trouble.
No, well, he's a player that makes something out of nothing. And players who do that, there's only a few players can do that. Not everybody can do them sort of things. And he's got an X factor about him. There's no doubt about it. And what Gibson's got to do is he's got to do those things like that. But what he's got to do, he's got to do the normal things consistently. That's what he's got to do, because he doesn't have to kick freaky goals. He doesn't have to take freaky marks. He doesn't have to dodge four blokes. That'll take care of itself. He just has to do the consistent, what do we call them? The simple things consistently. That's the word I was looking for. Great goal. Great goal, Gibson.
6 minutes of time on played in the second term, and Thunder have taken the lead with that goal from local hero Gibson Turner. 6-6-42, Thunder Southport, 6-4-40. Strong tackling in the middle. Vave in amongst the action. Surely the umpire's going to ball this one up. He will. Maybe time just for one more before the main break.
Yeah, well, there's probably...
have to be quick.
Yeah, no, look, there's plenty of time for one more from either side. So it depends who's going to get the ball out of the middle stand.
Jared Brennan copped one there. Put his head down and ran into it.
Doesn't
slow to get
good.
Up. Rosier's got the footy. Gives the handball off. Kick forward by Sam Talbot. Whistle's gone after disposal.
Yeah, downfield.
Free kick to Gibson Turner on the 50. Maybe this is a goal-scoring opportunity here for NT Thunder.
Well, that'll be a great for them to be able to come in front at half-time, Stan.
Gibbo too far out. Places it towards Ewing. Ewing one-on-one. Drifted wide of him and threw for one behind. Sort of a little bit of a nowhere kick, that one from Gibbo.
Yeah. Well, he's better at putting it in the goal square, and that's the sort of things that I'm trying to say about him. Like, just keep the simple things simple.
Yep.
Does that make sense? Or
now Southport, their turn to maybe take advantage, because they've moved the ball swiftly all the way up towards their half forward area. Justin Emery gets it off to Ben Rioli. Out of trouble now, Thunder. Rioli's kick bounces in front of Vaveway. He's going to have to be quick. The handball to Jonathan Paris. Paris the handball to Sam Talbot. Talbot with a bit of time. His kick is good. Gibson Turner takes the mark. In between wing and half forward for Thunder. He hits the ground running. Loves to play on Gibson Turner. Long kick. And caught behind on that occasion was Thomas Motlop. The Sharks defence up to the challenge once again. Through handball, they're able to work it out. Big Christian Brock gave it off, and now the kick will come towards the wing for Southport. Islet in late, too late to affect Thomas Tyne, who's taken the mark for Southport. Played on, into a little bit of trouble. Good enough, though, to get the handball off to Dylan Mutu. His kick, though, not good. And Justin Emery's marked on the centre circle for NT Thunder. Low trajectory pass, bit of a bullet. Jonathan Paris is marked at half forward. He goes deep inside 50. Ewing's got the sit on his opponent, read it better. Don't even think that was his direct opponent. That's a big ruckman, Christian Brock, back there, right on the halftime siren.
Yeah, look, that's a coach killer. That's a coach killer in terms of Nathan Bock for Southport. Is, you know, it's almost time, and then they get the ball and they take a mark.
Seconds. And Ewing can make him pay. He does. He's put his third goal on the board right on the halftime break, and Thunder go to the main break now. with a 9-point lead, 7-7-49, Southport 6-4-40. It was a real grinding term, that one, Gilbert, but yeah, you just sensed the longer it went on, the more Thunder were reeling in Southport, and eventually they've got their noses in front.
Oh, look, absolutely. As it wore on, because they were a couple of goals behind at quarter time, and they wore them down, and then they got in front, and then Southport would get answer with a goal, and then Thunder would answer back. So for Thunder to go in at half time now with a 9-point break, that's momentum. And as a coach, that's what you want. You want momentum going into the start of the third quarter, so that gives them a lot of confidence, Stan.
They actually kicked four goals for that term to one goal two, and it just didn't feel like they dominated that much. 4-4 to 1-2, so it's a pretty handy scoreline for a quarter of footy, and it gives them that break at quarter time. We'll go through the goal kickers. Suddenly Darren Ewing's got three on the board. 2-2 Liam Patrick, both kicked in the first term, one each for Chris Dunn and the twister Gibson Turner. And for Southport, 2 to Josh Hunt, 1 each to Glenn Screech, Jack Anthony, Jared Brennan and Dylan Troutman. Entertaining half of football, Gilbert. You can't ask for much more. We've had some great highlights. An absolute screamer from Liam Patrick. Some quality goals. One from Jared Brennan that we'll remember for a long time. And good open attacking footy from both sides. Good first half. Looking forward to the second.
Yeah, don't go anywhere. You stay tuned because it's going to be a ripper of the second half. And more importantly, the third quarter. The premiership quarter, as they say.
That it is. And you'll get it from Traeger Park, the centre of Australian football.
Rising.
Make welcome back to the field your territory team, the NT Thunder.
Welcome back to our coverage of the Round 18 NEAFL match between NT Thunder and the Southport Sharks during the halftime break. A big thank you to the halftime entertainment situated over the far side of the ground, Gilbert.
Well, we've got some young Alice Springs people, and hey, mate, they can dance, they can rock too, you know, because we just had a look, and they've got the moves, mate. I get excited because you only see that in the city. You're not meant to see it. I get happy because it's been done in Alice Springs. Well done, girls. Good stuff.
PA music half-time around the ground, and the young ladies on the far side of the ground sitting on the grandstand seating over there keeping themselves warm in these 1-degree temperatures and keeping in time with the music on the PA.
It's good entertainment, especially in Alice, because it's freezing. We want to be warm.
Second half to get underway. The footy's been hot. It might be cold outside, but the footy's been hot. Thunder leading 7-7 to Southport 6-4. There's the second half about to get underway with the umpire throwing it up after not quite getting the bounce right to start things.
Yeah, no, seriously, Stanley, crucial quarter this one. Obviously, this is going to set it up for the last one, so this quarter will go a long way to the side winning, whichever side wants to dominate this quarter.
You called it the premiership quarter when we went to the halftime break. Liam Patrick's got a kick inside the attacking 50 for Thunder. Gibson turning there one way, then the other. Ran into a teammate. Quick kick out of defence by Stephen Tyne for the Sharks. Big Christian Brock there. He's got some hard work to do at ground level. He's done all right. Ryan Smith in there as well. Little nudge on his opponent. Jason Burge, a foot on the footy, sent it out wide and over the boundary line for a boundary throw-in right in front of the McMahon Services sign. Great sponsors of NT Thunder.
Yeah, great stuff, McMahon. And, well, they've been around in this town for a long time. I remember in the 70s, for sure.
Doing all the earth-moving work as Thomas Motlop gets a quick kick to bounce up towards a half-forward flank for NT Thunder. Then he goes back in and applies a tackle on Josh Hunt, and then somehow got a quick kick out of the pack. Drifted up towards the attacking 50. Strong hands on it. Blake Erickson couldn't take the mark for Southport. They're in over the top. What's the umpy going to do here? He's going to call for a ball up 50 out from goal.
Yeah, he wasn't circling, so. they just got to let him go and let him have a real good contest this quarter.
Big Bock probably had the better of that ruck contest. Sent the footy out to the boundary. Dom Barry was leading in the race for it over the boundary line again for another boundary thrown. Got to give it to the undermanned or undersized NT Thunder ruckman Ryan Smith and Neil Veve. They've broken even.
Yeah, well, they've almost double teamed him, and that's what clubs do to Goldstein from North Melbourne, because you know he's going to run all day.
There's a free kick picked out here. It's going to Cameron Island on the half-forward flank, about 70 metres out from goal. I think the ump is called into play on now. He'll place the kick inside 50 and place it beautifully onto the chest of Julian Lockwood. Has kicked it to where Lockwood needed to get to, I reckon.
You know what I was impressed about that is the space that the forward line created for Lockwood to be able to run into that space, because the Southport players, somebody should have been blocking that hole, because that's what defenders do. And obviously, they weren't communicating then, so that was smart by Ollett to be able to do that.
Important shot at goal here. Chance for Thunder to get off to a little bit of a flyer in the second half and extend their lead. Julian Lockwood's had a couple of shots for goal.
And missed.
This one, I reckon, is the closest one, though. The others were from out around about 50. This is 45. He pokes at it. It's not going to be a goal. Didn't have the distance. Big Ryan Smith. The ruckman snaps with a left boot and it cannons into the goalpost for a point. Gee, that would have been a bonus goal from your ruckman.
Well, that was almost a difficulty. You know the gymnastics, they do the difficulty of 9.5 or something? That was the difficulty of 10.5.
You almost had to do that, what do they call those people that can stretch like elastic?
Oh, just say the gadget man or something. So inspect the gadget, that's the word.
The big fella there, not quite as flexible this time. The footy's gone straight between his legs. Matt Rosier picks it up, wrapped up in the tackle straight away, holding the ball. Don't know where Rosie's prior opportunity was. Tyler Cornish has got it. And he passes off to Glenn Screech, who marks it centre half-back. Short pass from Screech is good. He gets it to Jason Burge. Burge now longer to the half-forward flank. Jack Anthony's taken a stack of marks out on that half-forward area tonight. Anthony long with the kick.
Great kick.
A couple of little short ones here. A little bit of a nudge out in the marking contest. The umpire spotted it. Justin Emery's. Yeah. Free kick, a couple of hands in the back there from Rob Clements.
Yeah, I was just going to say, look, that was almost coast-to-coast end. Territory Thunder get the goal. They go 16 points up. Southport get that goal, back to 4 points. It's a fine line, stand, but it can make a massive difference.
Cameron Island with a footy, deep in the back pocket for NT Thunder. Kicks out to the Todd Riverside wing, looking for Chris Dunn. He was slung out of the marking contest. It's not Chris Dunn. In fact, it's Ryan Neahus. He made sure the umpire noticed that. The whistle's been going all night, so definitely should have went then. And Ryan Neas with the free kick. Short pass to Justin Emery. Emery longer to the wing. Liam Patrick's taking the mark. Whistle's gone again after disposal. Yeah. Patrick will play on with the advantage out on the wing, but they won't let him.
He's paid a 50-metre penalty because there's been some back chat.
So that should be Liam Patrick, who will come from the wing to the 50 then, maybe.
Well, it was actually Anthony that said something. So the umpire's called a 50-metre penalty. Will it go downfield or will the player with the ball go the 50? It's given him two 50s. What's going on here?
Wow.
Well, I don't know what's happened, Stan.
It's not the most I've seen here. The late, great Eddie Taylor, I saw him give three 50-metre penalties and it was against the people out the front of the chain rooms. No one on the 50.
Yeah, well, let's not talk about that because...
Well, there's two to Liam Patrick. He's gone for the wing to full forward. Certain goal for Thunder.
Well, it's undisciplined, Stan, because it now they get the opportunity to go 16 points clear now, whereas could have been 4 points. That's going to make it hard, and I'm sure Nathan Bock, he'll be disappointed, mate, because coaches hate undisciplined stuff, and that was undisciplined.
Oh, it's been a tight contest, and just to give away a goal from 100 metres away like that, that's devastating. And Liam Patrick, no mistake, from point-blank range. He's got his third. NT Thunder, 8-8, 56. Southport, 6-4, 40. That margin now, 16 points. They get the next one, Gilly, and they're looking good.
Yeah, absolutely. And, look, I mean, it's only the first 5-6 minutes of this quarter, so... Look, that might fire the Southport guys up. Who knows what might happen, because they need to find a bit of steel. We call it steel.
So out of the middle, looking for a bit of steel, is Tyler Cornish. Ball ends up in the hands of Darcy Trask. Forward over there, just to Thomas Motlop, though, for Thunder. Onto the left boot. It drifts out wide. Todd Rivers side of the ground, leading in the race for the footy out there. Sam Talbot taking the ground. As soon as he got the footy over the shoulder, the ump, he says. Talbot gets the free kick, half-back flank. It's a famous name here in Alice Springs, your old club, Darren Talbot, a Minahan medalist. He's now coaching them.
Yeah, and he's actually won the premiership with them last year. And I know they're not doing flash this year, but they got a lot of young kids, so he's got some good development going on.
Thunder moving the ball out of defence. Eldridge got it to Paris. Paris hugs the boundary line with a kick. Justin Emery marks about a metre inside the boundary line, half-back flank. Kicks to the wing. Oh, plenty of space there for Thomas Motlop. Took it, but didn't take off. Stopped and steady. Now he'll play on. Kick out wide. Young Hagen. One-on-one marking contest there. So coming in now, Eldridge. Eldridge can't break three. Free, a quick kick scrub forward by the Sharks, taken by Josh Hunt. Shrugged off the tackle. The handball to Darcy Trask. He's handball to Tyler Cornish. Cornish kicks inside 50. It's been good movement of the footy. Thunder defenders got back in numbers, though. 3-on-2, they outnumbered him. And Neos gets a handball over to Bugler. And Bugler's short pass to Paris is good. He's taken the mark on the defensive 50.
Yeah, and that's the Thunder blokes, because Southport should have had a crummers there to go front and square to Anthony when it comes to ground. And the Thunder players ready to batter, Stanley.
A lot of space on the Todd River side of the ground now for Thunder. Ooh. Aaron Motlop spilt the mark. But that's how much space he had. Plenty of time to pick the footy up again. Kick away towards the wing. Didn't find the target. Some slick hands there by Southport. Got the footy to Thomas Tyne, and his pass forward is good. Glenn Screech has taken the mark just inside the boundary line. In between wing and half forward, he'll centre it up. The short pass to Darcy Trask.
Stan, I've got to say it, because the camera will be on that tree. And see that tree in the background, if you can see it. In Alice Springs, we call it the tree of knowledge. That tree has been around, and it knows everything that everybody's said over the years.
Many a knowledgeable comment has come over the fence from underneath that tree, directed towards the umpires more often than not. Bit of noise over there earlier today when South were playing too. Chris Dunn with the footy for Thunder. He's kicked it out of bounds on the full.
Well, but before, when I was a kid growing up, that was actually flat, and we used to park our cars, yeah. And that tree used to create a lot of shade for our people.
It's not always cold like it is at the moment. Early in the season and late in the season in finals, that would be the nicest place to be here, because the sun does beat down.
And that's where we thaw out. That's what we say, thaw out.
Eldridge using his pace down there in the back line this time for Thunder. Ball over the boundary line. Now the boundary throw in. It's about 50 metres out from the Sharks' goal. A little bit of an arm wrestle going on now, Gilly.
Yeah. See that tree? It's about 70 metres out from goal. I've seen Adrian McAdam do a torpedo and kicked it straight through the middle one day.
I've seen actually a bloke we watched earlier today too. Gilbert Fish will probably do about the same thing too. Southport have got a free kick here. 55 out from goal. Thought about a little play on there, Rob Clements, and changed his mind. I think he's worried about the distance. He's very short in stature. Long way for a bloke of that size. He just pops it up towards a hot spot. Brennan came in late. Vey got a fist on the footy. Darcy Trask takes it, taken high by Philip Wills. And Trask will get a free kick 45 metres out from Southport's goal. If he has a shot, he'd be kicking from right on 50. Yeah, after that first goal in the second half to Thunder, it's just been a bit of ebb and flow. Southport needs some attacking. They need a reward.
Well, the good thing that Southport's done is they've stopped Thunder from scoring more. So, more importantly, they have to score this one.
Darcy Trask from about 49 metres
out. Great kick.
It is a good kick. He's put it through. Southport got the goal they needed. Mm. They creep a little bit closer, moving on to 7 goals, 4:46. 10 points the margin. Thunder are 8:56. Just over 10 minutes gone at third term. Southport hanging in there.
Yeah, they are, Stan. And it's funny, you know, after that undisciplined act, isn't it funny that they've actually switched on, and the last 5 or so minutes they've played better than Thunder? So sometimes something like that can either make you go one way or can either make you go the other way. And
drop the bundle completely.
Exactly, and that's where you need leadership, and you need people like Hunt and Brennan and blokes that have been there and done it at that higher level. So that's important.
Kieran Brennan and Neil Vey in the ruck. I don't know what the umpire calls there. It's a free kick to Brennan. Neither of them got near the footy. I think we've seen earlier in the game too, Vey sort of looks at him and jumps into him rather than looking at the footy.
Yeah, well, I think if you've got your eyes on the ball, the umpire will let it go. If you haven't, they'll probably penalise you.
Oh, some courage there. Ben Rioli backing back. Josh Hunt came from behind and took the strong grab. Gee, Ben Rioli, he knew what was coming too.
Oh, that's
enormous
guts.
Courage.
I was going to say,
he's a bit sore in the back.
Well, he's a skinny little kid, mate, and he's got guts, mate. For him to back into a Hunt, look how big a Hunt is. Hunt's got legs bigger than tree trunks. no doubt about that. And, gee, they're making the changes, Stan.
Aren't they? There was some traffic down there at the interchange gates as Josh Hunt comes in to shoot for goal. He's kicking well tonight.
Ooh,
he's got three now.
Game on.
Suddenly two quick goals to Southport, and they're right back in it, only 4 points behind Thunder. Thunder 8-8, 56. Southport 8-4, 52. 12 minutes gone, third term.
Yeah, and we spoke about Hunt before, and, you know, he kicked two goals in the first quarter, I think, Stan, and... You know, I think this is his third now, in the third for the match.
As a Geelong supporter, I'm starting to think he was poorly coached and played out of position at the Cats.
Oh, but in reality, I think, you look at Stevie J and all the blokes up there and Hawkins. Well, I don't think they need him up there, mate.
There's a few Andy ones around. he's been deadly in front of the big sticks tonight, Josh Hunt. Suddenly, it's game on again. Thunder's 16-point lead evaporated, back to 4 points. A couple of quick responding goals to Southport. Hard work in the middle of the ground there. Got a handball out. Chris Dunn now. Southport here. They come streaming forward again. Darcy Trask starting to get a bit of the footy. Mm. Kick goes inside. 50.
Kick.
Jack Anthony. Mark on the chest. And he can go back and line up a goal. And he can put Southport in front. And who would have thought that about 3 minutes ago?
Yeah, well, I'll tell you why Southport are dominating, Stanley. It's because they're winning the taps from the centre bounce. And I'll tell you what, the Christian Block... He's dominated. All of a sudden, they're getting first use of the ball. And more importantly, that never touched any of the Territory Thunder's hands. That went from the centre straight to him. He's got to kick this, because if he kicks it, he'll make a statement. And I'll tell you what, they're going to hit the lead.
He's kicked one so far, Jack Anthony. I reckon he'd be in double figures for marks, and most of them inside 50 too. Kick on its way from about 35 directly out in front, and he's hooked it. He's missed it. Through for a point. Thunder stay in front by 3 points. 8-8, 56, Southport, 8-5, 53. It's about all he hasn't done. He hasn't really hit the scoreboard, just the one goal.
Well, from what I've seen him, I haven't seen any weaknesses in him, but I'll tell you, I think that's his weakness, is shooting for goal. And you know what? That's something you can correct.
Oh, Ryan Smith, oh, he took the mark from the kick in, but the umpires have been at least consistent with this. If there's been a nudge, they've paid it, and it's gone against Smith.
No, and I said before, I don't mind it if they do it, but honestly, they're consistent, because then everyone knows what's going on.
At least they have been with it. They keep playing. It is a chance. Crumbing off the pack. Oh, good pressure, though, by the Thunder defence. So the ball over the boundary line. Boundary throw in right underneath the Ted Hayes scoreboard.
Yes, well, he's been a great contributor to Alice Springs football. Ted Hayes, don't worry about that. And I remember the old stand that used to be here was called the Ted Hayes. And, yeah, now, look, my dad knew the great man Teddy Hayes, and my dad just spoke very highly of him.
He donated the old grandstand. Might have built it or helped.
I think he actually built it himself.
Yeah. But we've retained the name on the scoreboard over there. Electronic scoreboard at Traeger Park too. That's not something you would have dreamt about.
Well,
years ago.
I don't think he would have thought about that when I was a little kid, that's for sure.
Beautifully read off hands. Thunder streaming forward down that far side of the ground.
Gibson
turning, just a bit too wide for him to run onto it. It was Matty Rosier out on that far side of the ground.
Yeah. And I've got a lot of time for Matty Oregon. He's a great little player. And if there's anything that he needs to work on, sometimes his skill kicking lets him down. But, look, I mean, you can't estimate his ball-getting ability.
Yeah, that shortened stature play, 40 metres is about his distance. Dom Barry's been allowed to run on with the advantage here. We might get another local goal. Dom Barry runs in and puts it through.
Ooh.
Thunder get an answering goal. It's kicked by a Centralian. And they now lead 9 goals, 8.62 to 8.553, and one they needed.
Well, just, you know, it's the tide's just swung, you know, from side to side, and just when you think one side's getting on top of the other side comes back, and what a great game of footy. They just won't go away from each other, and I know Southport are actually seventh on the ladder, and I know they're trying to chase that sixth spot, so they've got a lot at stake. You know, I mean, it's not that Territory Thunder haven't got anything at stake, but I think Southport have got more at stake, because if they lose this one, it might just take away their final six spot.
And they're a proud club too, mate. Before the NEAFL days, they were the powerhouse.
Mate, I know, because when I played with the Bears, mate, they were known as the premiership team of the Quaffle, as they say.
Yeah, Territory...
They were the St. Mary's of Queensland football. That's a good way of looking at it.
Or a pioneer.
From the Alice Springs League. You're spot on, Stan.
They're a proud club.
No, they are, mate, and they've had some champions. At the footy club, don't worry about that.
Big Ryan Smith beaten in the ruck contest, did the roving, got the kick forward. The umpire's going to bring the footy back, though.
Just to name a few, Warwick Kappa, Stevie Lawrence, Marcus Ashcroft.
Rattling them off,
mate. Oh, mate, I can go on and on if I want to, but, mate, they produced a lot. BT, the great man Brian Taylor, they call it the footy factory.
Is that where David Bain came from as well?
Bainey might have come from there. We'll have to ask our Southport mate. He'll remind us of a few names.
Yeah, Cameron Islett just going across the ground. There's no one behind the player he kicked it to, Jason Bugler. So no one really forward or centre as far as Southport are concerned. Thunder move it up to the half forward flank. Richard Tamling's now got it. A lot of traffic in front of him. Tamling puts it out in towards the pocket. Big fist on the footy there for Southport. Sees it over the boundary line. We'll get a boundary throw in. About 50 out from the Thunder goal. 9-8-62 leading Southport. 8-5-53. 17 and a half minutes gone. Third term. Critical period of the game. Neither side able to really break clear of the other. Thomas Motlop reads the footy off hands. Kicks with the left boot. Back inside 50. Off hands. Michael Hagan.
Well done.
Comes back to Hagan. Copped a little bit of a nudge from behind. Done with the footy. Can't get boot to it. Only about 5 metres out. Good defence by Southport. We'll get a ball up only a couple of metres out from goal.
Yeah, great defence there by the Southport players. And in effect, he could have probably punched it through, Stan.
Oh, what's going on here? Whistle's gone. Thunder player got a soccer on that too. Might have been a goal, but it's a free kick to Southport. The big fella, Christian Bock, is going to take it. Been pretty handy for him, the big ruckman. And he pumps it long too. Nice looking kick. Got it well outside the defensive 50. Tamling was in the marking contest for Thunder. They managed to get a kick away, get it inside the attacking 50. Julian Lockwood runs onto it, goes in towards goal, and he's missed.
Oh,
gee, the big fella just can't buy one.
He's a bit like Anthony from the Southport. They seem to they can't buy goals, them two. But they get a lot of shots. But they take marks and do the marks inside 50 and that. But look, that's an area they need to work on because, well, it could win them games or lose them games. Simple as that.
Thunder 9-9, Southport 8-5. The margin 10 points. Josh Hunt with a thumping kick in out to the Todd Riverside halfback flank. Big fella managed to scrub another little kick forward. Eldridge into the action there. Now down on hands and knees. Little kick forward by Ryan Neas. Gained about 10 metres for Thunder. Christian Brock again, the ruckman. Slams it onto the boot and he sends it back forward in the Sharks' direction. Bugle overruns it. Waiting behind him though, Ben Rioli. His kick out wide. Big Ryan Smith gallops after it. The big fella. A little bit of a fumble. Handball back inboard. Eldridge has to wait for it. Good play by Southport. Running off their half-back line. And now able to clear with a kick up towards the wing. Bugler, a fist on the footy, sees it over the boundary line. Boundary throwing. Good play off half-back by Stephen Tyne, though, for Southport.
Well done by Bugler then, because there was two Southports on the one, and Benny Rowell was in front of him. But if it would have bounced the other way, the Southport would have cleaned that up. So great punch by Thunder, Bagley.
Veve in the front position. He got the tap down towards Wills. Wills handed it over to Thomas Motlop. He managed to get a little bit of a torpedo with that kick forward up to the half-forward flank. Ball taken off hands by Wade Mills. Gave it over to Glenn Screech. Little kick across ground to Darcy Trash. Now Southport go forward. Trash passes a good one too to the half-forward flank. Taken by Dylan Troutman. Troutman goes long to the hot spot. Anthony got rid of him and stood in front and took the mark. Go back and shoot for goal.
He's
played on with a handball to Hunt. And Hunt will bang it through for his fourth. Anthony can't kick him, so give him to someone who can.
Maybe he wasn't confident enough, but nah, look, I actually thought that they were going to give a free to Jared Brennan then, because I think he actually got infringed. But anyway, he marked the ball, they play it on, and Josh, what's that for?
Four.
Why didn't he play in the forward line? Well, they didn't need him at Geelong, that's why.
Anthony could have had a couple. He would be close to about 12 marks and 10 inside 50 marks.
There's something about Anthony, there's no question about it. And mate, if he can work on his kicking, the amount of times he gets the ball, he could kick probably 70, 80-odd goals in a season. I don't know what his previous goal-kicking seasons have been, but there's something about him. He's a match winner, that bloke. He's a match winner. He'll win it off his own boot.
I reckon the scoreboard here at the ground's wrong. 9-9 to 9-5 is what I make it. I make it only 4 points of difference in favour of NT Thunder. Southport trying to go forward out of the centre. Big Veve comes through. Nice pickup. Got the handball over the top. Little bit of a fumble by Aaron Motlop. On the hands and knees, Lockwood tried to get a handball. Now the Sharks link up. It's Wade Mills getting a handball over to Jason Burge. Burge kicks it out wide. Darcy Trask has had a nice quarter. Left footer kicked a goal earlier on in the term, and the pass is good, and he's got it to Anthony again. Now he's taking a mark out on the wing.
He plays like Nick Riewoldt. He's all over the ground. Doesn't matter where he's. He's up the wings. He's back at inside the forward 50.
He just keeps presenting. Aaron Motlop, the handball to Neil Veve. He hands it off to Cameron Islett. Long handball backwards from him to Thomas Motlop again. Now the Aaron Motlop was poked a little one out into the back pocket. Oh, Jonathan Perris went the one hand, couldn't pull it in. Ran into a little bit of traffic there with his own teammate Rosier. Attempted kick forward, was smothered off the boot of Stephen Tyne. Picked up now though by Ben Merritt, who goes in towards goal.
It's free kick for Southport.
Footy will come back to Merritt. Ben Rioli had stopped the goal anyway. Merritt will get another ping. He'll kick from right on 50.
When he plays on like that, is it play on? Because the umpire actually called it back.
Gee, you might have to keep hold of the score. He's a bit of a problem on the scoreboard. It's nil all now.
Well, I think that computer needs to be... I think it needs a new battery or something because it's just gone AWOL.
We went to an excellent game of footy in halfway to the third quarter. It turned into a game of soccer. Nil all. Ben Merritt to shoot for goal. I reckon this will put Southport in front as Thunder score starts to tick over on the scoreboard now. Merritt from right on 50.
Oh,
it's a good looking kick. Close to the line. Was it touched? I reckon it's through for a goal. It is goal on the board to Southport, and they take the lead by 2 points. 3 minutes into time on in the third quarter. Well, I tell you, when Thunder got the first goal of this term, Gilbert, I thought they were going to march away with this, but... credit to Southport. It's probably the second time they've done it in this game. Just when it looked like the opposition was on top, they've dug deep and they've worked their way right back into it. And now in front.
From what I've seen so far this year, Territory Thunder seem to lose at home. They seem to win away. And I don't know what sort of a trend that is, but...
record in Alice isn't flattering.
It isn't flattering either?
Probably 50% success rate at best. I might even be generous there.
Yeah.
So it's not a home game for all the Darwin blokes. They only come down here once or twice a year, and it's
well,
another trip away.
Well, that's one way of looking at
Tambling,
it, I suppose.
Tambling, lovely pass out of the middle to Liam Patrick. This is what they need. He's taking the mark inside 50. Mm. And the Lajamani lightning bolt goes back to line up for his fourth. I reckon he's probably only had the three kicks prior to this.
Well,
three goals.
And, yeah, but that's his quality. Yep. He doesn't need much of the ball to make an impact. Because you know when he gets it, he's going to do something with it. If he's not going to take a specky, he's going to kick a goal.
They need this one too, Thunder, just to turn it back around and get their noses back in front. Momentum, very important in footy these days. And he can stop the Southport momentum with an accurate kick here. Liam Patrick. From about 35, 40 metres out, 45 degree angle, we're right behind it. Oh, he's hit the post. Point on the board and the margin now, just 1 point. Southport leading 10-5, 65. Thunder 9-10, 64. Josh Hunt to bring the ball back into play. Look at that kick straight up the middle. I don't reckon it got any more than head height the whole way and got it to centre half back. Plenty of pressure here being applied by Thunder. Some good tackling. Tambling applies one now. Southport probably had a couple of opportunities to get away. Now they will. Free kick paid for player held when not in possession. So Jason Burge, been handy for them. Kicks towards halfway flag. That was courage again, Ben Rioli, running with the flight of the football against two opponents. Ryan Smith slams it onto the boot. Awkward bounce up to the wing. Socket off the ground by Nicholas Crowley. It's probably the right thing to do in the end. He gained his team about 40 metres, got it out wide. Ben Rioli there to pick it up just inside the boundary line for Thunder. Concedes some ground with the kick, but gets the footy to Cameron Island inside the defensive 50. Switch a play to the grandstand side. Over to Jonathan Perris.
Oh.
Perris goes long and high. Gee, it wasn't to the advantage of Motlop. Good discipline punch from behind, though. Got the footy down to Neas, who gave it back over to Perris by hand. Now Perris runs down the wing. Two bounces. Kicks, looking for Ewing a long way out from goal, looking for the free kick. Hagen gets the crumbs, onto the boot. Turner waiting for it at the top of the goal square, and he takes the mark. The twister, Gibson Turner will go back and line up for goal from about 20 metres out. Young Michael Hagen getting involved as well.
Yeah, look, that was a great kick too, because You know, he probably could have had a shot, but that's team orientated stuff, and that's what you want to do. Just put it up there and give the bloke an opportunity, and he should kick this Gibson.
Gibson Turner, the goal umpire's done a little bit of work to his left, but it's still a goal on the board, and Thunder now back in front. 10 goals, 10-70, Southport 10-5-65.
Yeah, look, still plenty of time, Stan, and unbelievable. This is 10 goals, 10 to 10 goals, 5. That's good kicking for Southport. Bit more better than Territory Thunder, and you know it's probably good kicking that's going to win you the game, obviously, because you're going to kick goals.
Well, Southport could get over the line here with less scoring shots the way they're going about it, and it's always a terrible feeling with the team that's kicked more scoring shots and lost the game.
It's a
real hollow loss, that one.
Yeah, well, it's almost like you've lost more than they've won it.
Gee, Big Smith's done pretty well at ground level a couple of times with centre clearance kicks. There's another one. Ewing's got it. Tried to get the handball off to a teammate. Was partly smothered. They still try and push that ball through. Southport's defence able to hold them up, and a ball up about 40 metres out from Thunder's goal. So a 5-point lead, 7.5 minutes of time on played in the third term. Probably time for a goal to one of these teams. Thunder, the best opportunity with the ball at half forward. Little Hagen tried to toe poke it forward. Emery was there. Now he applies the tackle. The ball comes out just in time for Southport. Desperate stuff. That was a good clearing handball. Put the footy out in front of Burge. Burge tapped it to his own advantage and then followed up. Picks it up on the centre circle. We'll get the kick to go inside the attacking 50. Was over the head of the leader, Jared Brennan. Ben Rioli back there. The ball goes to the boundary line. And I'll just backtrack a bit and mention Harrison Fraser. I think you called him Birds getting that kick inside 50. Good play, Harrison Fraser. Boundary throw in. Footy just around from the Southport goal. They're down by 5 points. Closing stages, third term. Big Smith got the knock. Hit the footy back towards the boundary line. Brennan there to try and keep it in play. He can't. Ben Rioli right with him. And another boundary throw in, this time about 25 metres around from Southport's goal. Coach Xavier Clark will just be hoping they defend stoutly here and don't concede one.
Yeah, well, there's not a lot of time left in this quarter, Stan, so if Thunder can get a couple of goals up, that's going to be very handy. But if Southport can get the next one, will they go ahead? So, it's like I said before, it's a very fine line, and yes, that's just how it is.
Jack Anthony on the sidelines at the moment for Southport. They'll be keen to get him back out there. He's given them plenty up forward. Robbie Clements chases up the foot inside the boundary line. Tackled by Rosier. He is a terrier when he tackles Matty Rosier, and he's picked up the free kick. Incorrect disposal decision. Not much of him, but my goodness, he throws himself into every tackling opportunity that comes his way. Not a long kick, Rosier. Goes out wide towards the boundary line. That's a good strong mark too, front position, Luke Hill. Liam Patrick trying to get the fist on the footy, but Hill able to position his body and just protect the footy. He's looking up towards a pretty crowded attacking 50 for the Sharks. The kick will go to the top of the goal square. Hunt positioning, Bugler fist on the footy. Whistle's gone. Hunt taken out of the contest, was it?
Oh, I don't know about that.
Gee, there's been some free kicks in the marking contest in this one. A chance here for Southport to take the lead just before three-quarter time.
Yeah, look, I don't know. There wasn't a lot in that. The Territory Thunder guy did a great punch, and he was actually surrounded by two Southport players. There wasn't any other Thunder player in that vicinity, so I don't know where he's got that shepherding. Maybe, and I haven't got the replay advantage here, but yeah, I don't know about that one.
Josh Hart going for his fifth. A little bit of work to the left for the goal umpire, but 5 goals on the board to Josh Hunt, and Southport take the lead just before three-quarter time. They're up by a point, 11-5-71, Thunder 10-10-70. A lot of free kicks in marking contest. That one there to me, it looked like Hunt was almost circumnavigating the marking contest anyway to try and get around to the front and centre position. But
should have been play on. You know, like, that's a crucial... That, anyway, I've got to stop talking like this because that's me... that's my coaching or my football coming out of me. I've just got to keep my mouth quiet about the umpires and just let them play football.
And a few more players took that advice, mate. They'd be better off out there as well.
Yeah.
Once again, the umpire's going to have to recall the bounce. Happens a lot, doesn't it? They only got to do it in the centre of the ground now. They still recall about 50%.
I just don't like games getting dictated by whistles. That's what I don't like, Stan. And I don't want to keep going on about it, but leave it at that.
Been a few today. Lockwood working hard. Slammed the boot onto the footy to get it out of the traffic. Tom Barry leading the race out of the wing. Couldn't pick it up. Travis Motlop could. Gee, good effort. Kick around the corner's being marked by Vevey. Spots a player in a little bit of space in the centre of the ground. The pass was good to Sam Talbot. Talbot to Lockwood. Lockwood bounced off him like a pinball. Hagen, clever little kick over towards Gibson Turner. Here's the twister. Oh. He kicks right on 50 on the siren. No score. And at three-quarter time, Southport have taken the lead. They lead 11-5, 71. NT Thunder 10-10, 70. Again, Gilbert, another quarter where the momentum swung early on. It was Thunder. We thought, gee, how much here? They got a 16-point lead. Credit to Southport. They've come back again.
Oh, look, and this is what people love, our great game of Australian rules football, because at no stage can some team or some team get an ascendancy or dominate, because there's an opposition, and sometimes the opposition can make it hard for you as well. And this is what we want to see, and this is what the spectators have come to see. It's just a great game to call for us, Dan. And I'll tell you what, you wouldn't want to go anywhere now. Don't go to the toilet, or we want to go to the toilet now and have your quick coffee break and tea break, but you better come back, because we've got the last quarter coming on now.
Should be an absolute beauty. Only 1 point the difference. I can hear that music on the PA. That reminds me, I got told I've got to send a cheerio to the better half, Lynette. She loves this song, and she says, g'day, Gilly.
Oh, Lynette. Thanks very much, sis, and you're all the best, eh?
Love you, darling. Three-quarter time at Traeger Park, Southport leading by a point, 11-5-71 to Andy Thunder, 10-10-70. We'll be back with the last quarter shortly. Welcome back to our coverage of the round 18 game between NT Thunder and Southport Sharks. It's coming to you from Alice Springs and a chilly Traeger Park, the centre of Australian football.
Stan,
Gilbert McAdam.
Well, Stan, look, I've called that the MCG, I've called that Etihad, I've called that most places around Australia, but I'll tell you what. What is it when I come back home to my town, it seems to be more colder in Alice Springs than anywhere else in Australia, because that's how I feel at the moment. And my back, I cannot feel my back.
It is freezing. I'll tell you how cold it is. Levi from our production crew, he was doing laps of the McAdam Bowden grandstand during the three-quarter time.
Well, I think I should have been running up and down them stairs to keep myself warm.
Great game of footy on our hands. It's hot out on the field. A one-point lead to Southport at the final break. 11-5-71 to ND Thunder. 10-10-70. The ball's out on the Todd Riverside wing. Motlop the handball to Rosier, gives it to Dominic Barry, and a bit of strife. Oh, he's coughed it up. The kick's gone straight to Josh Hunt. Hunt plays on with the handball. Another handball over Tyler Cornish. Cornish goes long and inside 50. Anthony's marked everything that's come his way today. Almost pulled that one in. Bugler just managed to spoil. Rioli gets the handball off to Jonathan Paris, and now he kicks out to the halfback flank on the grandstand side, taking the footy on the run. Sam Talbot gives it off to Dunn. Dunn back to Talbot. Talbot a wobbly one inside 50. Rosier goes the one hand. Can't quite pull it in. He's quick to recover, Rosier. Oh, his handball astray. Gone to Glenn Screech of the opposition, but the whistle's gone. Free kick to Thunder.
Yeah, Rosier hit him over the head, Stan.
Oh, he's played on quickly. Wanted to get it on to Dunn. The umpire won't let him do that. He'll bring the footy back. And the reason he wanted to get it on quickly is because this is outside his distance, I think.
Yeah, no, look, he's struggled to kick 50. There's no doubt about it. And just put it to goal square.
Oh, he's gone for the pass. He's kicked it out in front of Darren Ewing. A couple of bounces before Ewing can get hands on the footy. Little handball out in front of himself, then the soccer off the ground. They had a player in the road. Mark taken by Nicholas Crowley for Southport.
Yeah,
just
I think
a bit messy.
I think Matty would have been better off just going to the goal square. At least that way you give yourself a chance. It's close to goals, front and square. Whereas if he kicks it out that way, it takes it away from the 50-50 circle, and you've got to keep it in there because backmen hate it when it's in the goal square.
Boundary throw in. Tambling affected a good spoil from the kick in. He's kept it in Thunder's forward half. That's important. Ruck work. Kieran Brennan probably had the better of it. Dom Barry gets it. The handball to Ryan Smith. Oh, he coughed it up quick, but got it back to Barry. Barry onto the left boot. It's a high floater. Lockwood in the front position. Couldn't quite take the mark on the chest. Now the footy up for grabs. Josh Hunt lurking in around there for Southport. Then he applies a very strong tackle. He just dumps him to the ground once he wraps him up. Tambling in low. Picks up the footy. Can't break free. And the ball up about 45 metres out from Thunder's goal. Southport leading 11-5-71. Thunder 10-10-70, 1 point the difference. 2.5 minutes gone, final term. A lot of wrestling in that ruck contest. Dom Barry starting to get a bit of footy. Onto the left boot, kick inside 50, punched away by the Shark defence. Footy, quick kick forward. The Docks almost came off, just done with the footy. He's been wrapped up in a tackle. And we'll get a ball up about 20 metres out from the Thunder goal. Luke Barthard is the number 17. Almost headed towards the Bath area. He had half the clothes off.
That's a player's worst nightmare is when you get your pants pulled down.
Big Ryan Smith trying hard after the ruck contest. Here's Gibson Turner. Can't twist his way out of that one. Somehow a handball came out. It's been called a throw. I did say somehow a handball came out. That's how, thrown out. Free kick for Southport. Luke Shreve wanted to play with a handball. The umpire won't let him do that. So Shreve will probably have to stick to the grandstand side instead of the switch he was thinking about. And he's looking for the big fella, Kieran Brennan, in front of Ryan Smith. Takes a mark. Been a good contest between the ruckman for both sides. Bugler positioned himself up.
Good
position.
Mark.
Courage.
I like
strong
this kid.
Overhead.
Something about this kid. Are you...
He reminds me of Dustin Fletcher.
He's a
real go gadget arms.
Yeah, but you know what? He's courageous and he put his body on the line. He don't care. He'll just go for it.
So he's kicked it up towards the attacking 50. Gibson Turner might have been the target there. Fist on the footy by Glenn Screech for the Sharks. Sees it over the boundary line. Boundary throwing 60 around from Thunder's goal. No score in this final term. 4 minutes gone. And a tight contest it's been for four quarters. It remains that way Philip Wills trying to break free with the footy. He can't. The umpire's going to ball it up again. 55 out from Thunder's goal. Bit of an arm wrestle early in this final term. Michael Hagen, the youngster, warming up on the sidelines. Xavier Clark getting ready to inject some pace. Here's Dominic Barry. It's about five possessions already in this final term. High kick, Ewing parked behind his opponent. Couldn't get it. Crowley did well. Got the little handball out to his teammate. And the long clearing kick out to the back flank came off the boot of Matthew Scully's being marked by Robert Blood. Blood towards centre half back. Mark taken by Luke Shreve. So Southport methodically moving the ball forward now.
Ooh, dangerous.
Sideways stuff. Cameron Islett got there. Stopped the mark by Glenn Screech. Then he applied the tackle. Now Gibson Turner's got it one way, then the other. Clever kick outside of the boot. Bounces nicely for Ewing. Ewing around onto the left. Snaps into the goal square. Patrick Marks. Just a metre out. He can go back and put it through for his fourth.
Yeah, and that was the kick that Southport... great stuff by Islett and Vivi to be able to turn that ball over then, because they gave it over to Gibson, and Gibson's obviously give it to Ewing, and great play.
Liam Patrick, fourth goal on the board, and Thunder back in front by 5 points, 11-10-76. Southport 11-5-71. That's the first score of the final term, and it took 5.5 minutes. It's been an arm wrestle.
Yeah, there's a bit going on out on the field. We've got the skipper in Glenn Screech. He's getting into he's getting into Ryan and Islett for, I don't know why, because I think Islett turned the ball over, but yeah.
I don't think I've seen Cam Islett get as upset as he has tonight.
Well, he's very calm. He's normally pretty composed sort of a player. I don't see him get upset. And
they've kept a tight handle on him too. Yeah. He hasn't had as much of the footy as he'd normally have either.
Well, they know that he's a danger man, because if he plays well, normally Thunder win the game.
So they've pushed him out of the midfield to a forward role now too, probably trying to break the tag that's been on him all night. Here they come out of the centre. Thunder, Chris Dunn, the little handball over the top. Neil Veve, 55 out. Kick to the goal square. One-on-one for Ewing. Oh, almost pulled it in. Soccer off the ground, just misses. Point on the board to Thunder. The margin now out to 6 points. Well, that would have been a handy quick one.
Well, that might be a handy point now, because, well, it's one goal the difference. Could go either way. Could be a draw. Could be one goal either side. And
just to have got a goal that quickly out of the centre to follow on would have been a real team lifter, I reckon.
Well, it would have hurt Southport, no doubt about it.
Now Southport showing some composure off half-back. Kick into the centre wasn't bad. Went through the fingers. Rosier comes through. He can't take the footy with him. Ben Merritt working hard for Southport. He did manage to get the footy out. And now a chance for him to go forward through Dylan Mutu. He's kicked to the 50. Anthony again. Strong hands. Just keeps taking marks.
Yeah, I think
too far out to score.
Well, I think his time at Collingwood, I don't think I've seen him kick too many goals, Stan.
I don't think I ever saw him mark like this. He places a kick inside 50. They had two waiting there, and Ben Rioli just couldn't get in to affect the spoil. Thomas Tyne held his ground and kept Rioli out of the contest, and the mark's been taken by Harrison Fraser. He can shoot for goal and tie up the scores here with a straight kick. He'll be kicking from 40 out.
Distance won't be a worry.
No, I wouldn't think so. Gee, it's been a good contest. Goal for goal. No one able to break away. This one sliding out of the right, and it hits the post. So Thunder's lead reduced to 5 points now. 8 minutes gone. Final term. Thunder 11-11-77. Southport 11-6-72. Thunder have kicked the only goal in this final term. Big bugler. The little kick to himself and then a run out into the back pocket. And then he thumps along. An absolute screamer out there on the half-back flag.
Gee. Who was that?
Oh, I couldn't pick him up. And that Thunder player got up high. I think it might have been Sam Tau, but it was. Short pass over to Dunn. We've seen a couple of screamers tonight. Liam Patrick early in the game, and now Sam Talbot pulls in a beauty.
Oh, what a time to do it too. When the game's at, it's crucial.
That should lift him. Lockwood with the footy on the wing. He looks for Liam Patrick, finds him. No, Neil Veve it is. Half forward flank now. Veve, he kicks in the Patrick direction. Won't quite get to him. Ewing juggles
yes.
it.
Yes, good mark.
Two grabs, takes the mark. He can go back and line up a goal from about 50 out. It does seem like a little lift in the atmosphere come from that, doesn't it?
No, it doesn't. He's had a pretty...
reasonable game, hasn't he?
Yeah, but probably... But boy, his standards probably quieter than he expects of himself, because he knows what he's capable of doing, you know, when he's at his best. And I know he's probably had a few touches here and there, but, you know, just when he gets loose, he's got to kick this.
Darren Ewing looking for goal number four, just offline. Gee, a couple of these shots are... really could have put some space between themselves and Southport. As it is, the margin is now 6 points. Thunder 11-12-78, Southport 11-6-72. Josh Hunt with the kick in. Another beautiful kick in it was too. Hit his teammate on the chest out there on the Todd River side of the ground. And that kick, marked just inside the boundary line. Thomas Tyne. Looked like it was sailing over the line out on the full. He's done well to rake that one in. No, lovely pass. Another mark to Anthony, who gave it back to Tyne.
Great handball, wasn't it?
Good work. It's a bit of a wobbly kick, this one, up towards the attacking 50. It's out wide as well, and Brennan can't control the footy over the boundary line, boundary throw-in.
I've noticed Anthony's playing up centre forward, and I've noticed Brennan's playing in the goal square. I'd be more inclined to bring Brennan up centre forward and put Anthony back in the forward line, because Brennan's going to be, you'd think he'd be more dangerous.
Well, he showed some glimpses early in the game, hasn't had a lot of footy late. He's the sort of player who could just produce it, didn't he?
Well, that's why you get him into the play. You don't just leave him out there in the wilderness. Put him in the play and let him be a part of it.
Tyler Cornish kicked it back in the Jack Anthony direction. He didn't get a go at that mark. Bugler there slams it onto the boot. A floating kick back outside 50. Juggling effort, and the mark taken by Christian Bock. The big ruckman, he's been handy. Kicks high. Anthony underneath it, and he's got another mark. Jonathan Paris just outbodied on that occasion. I don't think Anthony's his direct opponent, but he's the one that got close enough in the marking contest. And Anthony...
he's got to kick this one, surely.
He's only got the one goal, and this is a bloke I reckon's taken at least a dozen marks.
Well, I'll tell you what, if I was...
inside the 50-metre line.
Well, if I was a backman for Southport, I'd be taking him out to training on Monday and Tuesday, and I'll say, come here with me, because I kick the ball to you, and you miss all the time.
Well, this time he hasn't. He's put it through and he's tied up the scores. Jack Anthony does get his second goal. And 12 goals, 6-78 to Southport Thunder, 11-12-78.
Look, very much needed one. And that's what he's got to do, Anthony, because he can dominate. He can turn the game. He can win the game off his own boot. And I don't think he understands how dominant he is, because he should be doing more of it.
I'd be penciling him in for 3 votes tonight on the amount of possessions. The only thing he hasn't done is really hit the scoreboard.
I reckon he's taken nearly 15 marks. I mean, we don't get them sort of stats, but it wouldn't surprise me if he's got a dozen anyway.
He's grabbed everything, and they've all been one grab too. Well, game on. Scores level. 12 minutes gone, final term. Anyone can win this. Big Ryan Smith, he's done that a few times, the big fella in the ruck. Got the centre clearance kick off Patrick's hands. Tambling crumbed it. Just couldn't take the footy with him. Oh, a little smother there. Keeps it inside the 50. Gibson Turner tries to tap it to his own advantage. 40 out now from the Thunder goal. It comes to Tambling. Quickly onto the boot, into the forward pocket. And it bounces through for... no, bounces out of bounds. We'll get a boundary throw in right next to the behind post. Cameron Islett limping off, favouring maybe the left ankle or hip. Aaron Motlop on.
I reckon that happened in that contest before when he turned the ball over. But that's what happens. See, he puts his body on a line. He does it week in, week out, Islett. He does it every week for his mates.
Crashes his. Gibson Turner, snap a goal for Thunder. It's just offline and through 4-1 behind. That point is now what they lead by.
Let's hope he's okay, Stan, because, you know, that could be a turning point of this game, because he's so crucial to Thunder.
Well, they'll need him through the finals too. He's one of the most experienced footballers and a proven performer. They'll definitely want him for finals, so let's hope it's not serious at all. Bugler there, fist on the footy, sends it over the boundary line. She's tied at Traeger tonight, 11-13-79, 12-6-78, 1 point.
And I was going to say, look who ran up the ground to take the mark. Anthony, he was like back there, now he's running back to the forward line.
Yeah, he's covered some territory, hasn't he? It's been a great effort from Jack Anthony tonight, and Bugler's been a great player as well. It's a good contest, what a matchup. Anyone but Bugler on him, I wonder how influential he would have been. He would have absolutely slayed it. Here's Luke Barth. Gets the handball away to Ryan Nias. Awkward looking kick. Might bounce nicely for Tau, but he took a screamer early in the quarter from 50 out. He got right underneath the kick. Ewing works his way to the front. Oh, had a piece of it. Crowley there, and he's handballed that through for a behind.
Yeah, no, he's allowed to. Yeah. He's allowed to do that. He's under pressure, so he's allowed to do it.
2 points the difference.
I notice a lot of players, mate, they get flustered because they don't know what that rule's all about.
They want to watch some bush footy here. They don't rush nothing through bush footy, mate.
No, well, it's almost like you're holding your breath and it's like of anticipation of, oh, what did I do wrong?
Matthew Scully, a good mark inside the defensive 50 for Southport. They won't go away, the Sharks. It's a good kick too out to that far side wing. Harrison Fraser with it. Centres it back up. Mark taken on the chest by Wade Mills. Now Mills out to the half-forward flank on the Todd River side. Gee, that was well read by Richard Tamling. He takes a mark in the fingertips, tumbles to the ground and now gets to his feet. Former Richmond and Adelaide Crow player, and he's away now, Tamling. Goes long, he's looking for Liam Patrick. Out position, gee, that's a good mark. Luke Hill.
He's been impressive.
Done pretty well.
Yeah, no, he's been impressive. Him and Liam's had a real battle today. It's been a great contest. Oh, today, tonight.
four goals for Patrick, but he hasn't got the footy many more times than those goals.
Well, that's what I mean. Hill's done a terrific job to be able to keep it down to that much.
Kieran Brennan took the mark for Southport. Now he kicks it inside 50. Here, Jack Anthony again, another mark. Bugler getting frustrated. He's been called to play on. He slipped the handball off. Ping in towards goal.
Hunt again.
Oh, yes, they've got it. Josh Hunt can shoot for goal from only about 5 metres out.
Unbelievable.
Tightish angle. He's kicked five, Josh Hunt. Jack Anthony's taken all the marks and Josh Hunt's kicked all the goals. A chance at number six and a chance to put the Sharks back in front. He'll go with the banana. We'll wait on the goal umpire. He has missed.
Oh.
Well, he hasn't missed many tonight, Josh Hunt.
Nah, he hasn't.
Oh, and that halves the margin. It was 2 points and now it's 1 point again in favour of Thunder.
Don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere because this game's going to come right down to the...
It's been like this all night, though. You've been hardly been able to split these two teams. Great mark from the kick in Ryan Smith. Gets it moving forward quickly for Thunder. Kick towards the wing. Ewing a long way from goal. Oh, Lockwood floats across the front. Takes a nice mark.
How good
kicks
was that?
Forward looking for Liam Patrick. Patrick marks on the chest. 50 out from goal. Thomas Motlop streaming inside the 50 for him. The kick in that direction just a bit over his head. Bad bounce for Motlop. And now a chance for the Sharks under immense pressure deep in the defence. Wade Mills got a handball away. And now a clearing kick to the back flank. Gee, thought they were on there for a certain goal. Now the Sharks, their chance to go forward.
Anthony!
Here comes Anthony again, another mark.
That's number 25.
That one wasn't a one grabber. He did juggle it. Got the handball off to Dylan Mutu. Mutu kicks it forward. Here comes Southport again. Now there were a chance for Harrison Fraser. He goes long. And Josh Hunt's marked at the top of the goal square.
What a great kick by Fraser to be able to put it over and put it in front of him so he could run onto it. Great kick by Fraser then.
Jack Anthony limping towards the sidelines.
Well,
that's bad news for the Sharks.
Well, he was up that eye. He probably landed on his ankle because he looks like he's limping. He's landed on something. Great mark.
And Josh Hunt, the other ex-AFL star for them tonight, has kicked five and now he's going for number six. He won't be missing from there. He's not. He's kicked that one down to Belangle Street. And Southport are back in front. 13 goals, 7.85. Thunder, 11-14-80, 17 and a half minutes gone in the final term.
Well, you call it Belangle Street. I'll call it Belangle Street. Because I know that street because my grandmother used to live just down the road and we always used to come down and kick the football on this oval.
Auntie Daisy Hampton lived...
Auntie Daisy lived just there, exactly.
Yep, free entry to the town pool through the back fence, team, eh?
Yeah, I reckon I might have done that a couple of times over the years.
Gee, what a crowd used to be there, too. That's a big family, that one.
Yeah.
Cheerio to the Hampton family, too. Graham Chisel Hampton might be listening in. His son, Graham Jr., playing for West Adelaide these days.
Oh, great to see.
Good to see the tradition continue. We've got a game of footy on our hands here at Traeger. Southport are 5 points in front of NT Thunder. Getting close to time on. That's only about a minute and a half away. Veve doing the ruck work against Bock. The ball moving forward in Thunder's direction initially. Now taken by Tamling. He's had a good game. Floating kick. Lockwood there. He's been pretty good as well. Just can't buy a goal. Running onto it. Shot a goal. Hagen! Hagen puts it through. The son of Norm. A legendary goal kicker. His old man was it. Now the young fella, Michael Hagen, has put Thunder back in front.
Oh, great goal. And you know what? I talked about before about front and square and small forwards crumbing, and that's what he done, and that was his role, young Hagen, and that was great play by Lockwood that brought the ball down, and you know that's what the small men are there to do. They're there to read the play, crumb the ball, give me the ball, I'll kick the goal, and that's what he's done. Great goal, Hagen. Good Thunder start. Back in front.
And look, I mentioned in the call, Lockwood just can't buy a goal, but I tell you what, he's played his role at half forward, hasn't he?
Well, sometimes
he's contested, he's taken marks.
Well, he doesn't have to kick goals sometimes, Stan. As long as he gives out goals, that's good enough, you know. Like, it's all about sharing and caring and making your teammate a better player.
Oh, Thunder back in front by 1 point. A thriller at Traeger Park. The umpire spotted a freeze, called it a throw. It's going Thunder's way. Aaron Motlop with the footy in the middle of the ground. Jack Anthony champing at the bit on the sidelines here. He wants to get back out there. Not surprised. He bought his own footy. He's marked it all night. Chris Dunn kicks wide. Goes across ground to Bugler. Now Bugler to the half-forward flank looking for Luke Barthorne. Nice stretch and a mark in the fingertips.
Yeah, great mark.
Was the umpire called play on? Lockwood, the handball to Paris. Paris will get the handball back to Luke Barth. Barth onto the left boot. A wobbly one inside 50. Up they go. Liam Patrick hands on it. Couldn't mark it. Ewing after it. Taps it to his own advantage. Just won't sit for him. He gets another go. Ewing, he burns him off. Onto the left boot. And
oh, what a goal! Unbelievable.
Goal, Darren Ewing. And now Thunder 7 points in front.
Oh. How good was that?
Oh, that was terrific. He just burnt him off going at about 2 kilometres an hour. He doesn't move quickly, but they just couldn't get him.
Oh, and you know what the most amazing thing about what he just did? When he's running away from the goals. So he's actually running away from the goals, but he's trying to hook it back. Mate, that's hard to do. Not many people can do that. That's freaky skill, what he just showed then. And, well, if you wanted some inspiration, that's just inspired him. Well, that might be just enough to get him over the line. But still, there's still plenty of time to stand. I reckon there's about 5 minutes to go. So it's not over, don't get me wrong.
Only a minute of time on Tick David so far. And we've gone close to 10 minutes of time on in every quarter so far. 4 goals now to Darren Ewing. He's done it again. He just keeps bobbing up with them, doesn't he? 7 points of difference, Thunder leading. Seven more scoring shots, too. There it is, 13-14, 13-7.
Yeah, what do they say? Great players come to the fore.
Oh, gee, Vevey did well in the middle there. Got it to Tamling. Tamling gets a kick inside 50. Suddenly they're rushing forward, Thunder. Lockwood applies a strong tackle. That's good work by him. He's kept it inside the attacking 50 again.
Yep.
Ball up 45 out from Thunder's goal.
Well, they can afford to keep a dandy now, Stan, and they can even afford to keep possession now. They don't have to rush down the line. They can just put the pressure back on Southport now.
Free kick to Southport. Player taken high. Wade Mills to clear out of the back line. He does so with a sweeping handball out to Jared Brennan. Brennan kicks. There's Anthony again. Oh, he didn't take a mark for a change. The crumb's down to Vevey. He gave the handball off to Bugler. Bugler hits a bit of a torpedo. Wobbles inside 50. Here's Ewing again. Couldn't do an action replay.
Foot.
He's gone the right drop at the top of the goal square. Patrick's there. Turner. Turner goals.
That's the sealer.
He seals it for Thunder.
That's the sealer.
The twister, Gibson Turner's got his third. And you would think Thunder home now. The margin out to, what's that, 13 points.
Yeah, look, they've got to score 3 goals, Dan. And, well, in the words of the great Lee Matthews, if minutes go less than goals, well, it's almost impossible. And we're not quite at it, but we're almost there.
We're getting close. Value out of the forward line tonight. Ewing with 4, Patrick with 4. So their centre forward and full forward have kicked them. And then the crummer, Gibson Turner, 3.
Yeah, look, he's been terrific, Gibson. You know, he's obviously playing on his home turf, Alice Springs. And I'm sure there's a few family sanitaries of people that's come. You know, that's a pleasure. That's the pleasure that he's going to get in terms of the family coming to watch him on his home turf.
Turning it on, Gibson Turner. Here's Josh Hunt with his nose over the football for Southport. He's been one of their best tonight. He couldn't control it this time. Wills goes in all over the top of him. He was unlucky not to get a free kick. He goes straight back in to apply the tackle and we'll get a ball up on that Todd Riverside wing. 14-14, 98. That's NT Thunder score. Southport at 13-7-85. 13 points of difference. 3.5 minutes of time on played in the final term. Ball tapped out in front of Matt Rosier. Rosier knocks it a little bit further forward and gets it over the line. Keen eyes here, Gilbert. Just looking at that thrifty sign over there. It says thrifty in one bit and it says thrifty on the other bit. Bit of trivia there at the boundary throw.
Well, Stan, I've got to admit, mate, I'm starting to go blind in the old age, and I think I need a pair of glasses like you because I can't see that far.
Oh, you wing a chance again. Taps it over to Patrick. Only 5 metres out from goal. He can't pick it up. I'll give it to this desperate Sharks defence. They're trying everything under the pump here. It's only 5 metres out. They tried to get it to the boundary. Will's there, and eventually Southport, now through Mills, gets it away, and a clearing kick out to the halfback flank. They are desperate back there, the Sharks, and they've got to get it up the other end of the ground. Swift hands, Jason Burge involved. Little 1-2 exchange. Now he goes a short pass up to the wing. Got it to Josh Hunt. He's got a long leg on him. Hunt, he can get this well inside 50. That's exactly what he does. Trask trying to go make position for the mark. Ben Rioli judged it better. And he's taking it just inside the defensive 50. Quick clearing kick out to the grandstand side wing now to Luke Barth. He'll come wider still. Kick out to Ryan Nias. Nias could have slowed it down, changed his mind, and now he'll give away a little bit of ground with the kick and eat up a little bit of time going back to Thomas Motlop.
Yeah, they can go around and just keep the ball off Southport now. They can afford to do that.
5 minutes of time on have ticked over. Motlop short pass, and Julian Lockwood takes the mark. He keeps presenting the big fella. Halfback flank, grandstand side. Talbot, little wrap around, wants the handball. Lockwood thought about drawing the play, then went the kick in the end, and he found Michael Hagan a little bit of space on the wing, and Hagan hit the ground running after the mark. Kick is nice. Ewing, good body work. He turns around and runs onto the footy. Chance to kick a goal. He's got Tambling screaming for it in the goal square.
Handball.
Handball over the top. Tambling goals. Thunderer home.
Yeah.
Deserved goal, Richard Tambling, too, to be on the end of it, because he's been a consistent performer all night. And Michael Hagan, a little bit of spark on the wing.
Yeah, look, he's an excitement machine, Hagan. He can certainly make something out of nothing, and he's got brilliant pace, and you know what, he's got good skill as well. And you know what, at the end of the day, this is why Territory Thunder is second on the ladder, because they just never stop. You're going to get a four-quarter effort. And if you're the opposition player, and if you don't play four quarters, well, you're not going to win the game. And that's just about sums it up. Southport, seventh spot, trying to chase a sixth spot.
Well,
versus a second team. They're just quality Thunder, especially today.
A lesser team than Thunder wouldn't have answered the multiple challenges that Southport have continued to throw at them. It kept coming.
And you've got to give Southport a lot of credit, because they came here to play, and they know that if they win this game, they're a chance for the sixth. So you've got to give them a lot of credit for the way they've come out. They played really well.
And they're still coming again now, even though it looks lost. They're still moving forward. Kieran Brennan, the kick inside 50. Thomas Motlop, gee, he's been good sweeping back there in the back line throughout the game too.
Yeah, he has. But also, Stan, you look at the scoring shots at Territory Thunder, 29-20. Like, that's massive. So, you know, they've almost kicked themselves into a loss, and lucky and fortunate enough, they've hung on to win the game.
Ben Rioli, kick out to that halfback flank. Ryan Smith gave his opponent a fair old nudge to get him out of the contest. Chris Dunn there, couldn't keep it in play. Boundary throw in half-forward flank. Todd River side of the ground. Getting close to the end of the game, about 7 minutes of time on played in the final term. Thunder 15-104, Southport 13-785. That margin is 19 points. That's about as big as it's been all night too.
It has, and that's why it's been a terrific game to watch and commentate. It's been magnificent.
Anthony goes for another mark. Bugler, another spoil. The crumbs down the front. Southport poker kick into the goal square. Ryan Nias there on the last line of defence to clean it up, though, for Thunder. Kick went over Matt Rozier's heads into the waiting arms of Philip Wills. Wills onto the right boot quickly. Got the kick up to the wing at the back of the pack. Liam Patrick turns around to try and chase up the footy. Tambling also in the action. The ball comes over to Luke Hildo of Southport. Floating kick back towards their attacking 15. There's a pretty good mark taken too. Player showing some courage to run with the flight of the footy. Luke Shreve it was. His pass is good too. Hit a teammate on the chest. They've got it 50 metres out from goal. They've kept coming, Southport.
They haven't stopped.
The game's out of their grasp, but they just keep coming forward. Let's see if Jack Anthony can take one more mark. Bring up his ton. He's taken more marks than Australia made runs in the first innings of cricket the other
day. Well, I was going to say, you just want him to break the world record. That's all you want him to do.
So, shot at goal here for the Southport Sharks. He's offline and through for one behind. Dylan Troutman, that was there, having the shot at goal.
Yeah, no, to be quite honest, I don't think I've seen at this level, and I've done a few games, never seen someone dominate so much. Like Anthony did.
Travis Motlop takes the mark from the kick in, continuing to rack up the possessions in this defensive role. In short pass back to the bugler. And now he goes out wide into the back pocket, and Jonathan Perris has taken the mark, chewing up some time here now, Thunder, as Perris kicks it back to Bugler. They'll just be happy to take the four premiership points. They're waxing these two. Bugler back to Perris again.
Yeah, they're just killing time.
It's the old lunchtime in the schoolyard, isn't it, when you wax. Short pass now to Thomas Motlop getting in on the action. On the defensive 50, short pass from him, and now Chris Dunn's got it.
Yeah, not a lot. Almost time.
Chris Dunn only the one goal this evening, so they've done it without his usual 2-3-4 goal contribution. There's the siren, and Thunder win it at Traeger Park. 15-14, 104 to Southport, 13-8-86. A great game of footy, Gilbert, and yeah. In the end, Thunder just able to pull away when it counted.
Oh, look, absolutely. And you know, from the game, from the first bounce to start the game, stand, this game has been so close, and you know, it's been goal to goal. It's been 1 minute they're getting one goal, Thunder, next minute Southport getting a goal, and you know, you thought Southport were getting on top at some stage, and then all of a sudden Thunder would come back, and then you thought Thunder were getting on top, and then Southport would come back, and just the quality of football. I was very impressed with the quality of the football, the standard very high, and look, I just like to think that both sides gave them everything today, and Southport obviously knew that they had to give it their all, because they're fighting for a top six spot. And Thunder, well, it's all about their pride and the Guernsey, and even though they're in second, and you know, they've got to try and get that double chance, I suppose, in that second. So they had a lot to play for as well.
Got to keep winning to hold that second spot. Then yeah. There's rewards that come with second spot when you head into the final. So you really want it. You don't want to slip up and drop back to third. The way you said the game fluctuated, indicated by the quarter-by-quarter scores. Southport yep. led by 11 points at quarter-time. Then Thunder led by 9 at
yes.
half-time. Southport were back in front by a point at
three-quarter-time.
And then Thunder turned it around to win it by 18. We'll give you the goal kickers for Thunder. 4 each to Darren Ewing and Liam Patrick. 3 to the Twister, Gibson Turner. And 1 each for Dominic Barry, Richard Tamling, Chris Dunn and the youngster, Michael Hagen. And for Southport, 6 goals to Josh Hunt. We knew him as a defender with the Cats, but great up forward for Southport tonight. 6 goals, 2 to Jack Anthony, who, for mine, Gilbert, I actually thought was best on ground. Anyone who can take close to 20 marks. The only thing he didn't really do was hit the scoreboard. Just the 2 goals, 1 each to Glenn Screech, Jared Brennan, Dylan Troutman, Darcy Trask and Ben Merritt. But entertaining game of football. Thunder hold on to second. Southport still sitting in 7th spot. It's a tough one for them now. They've got to come home with a wet sail to snatch 6th spot and get themselves into the final. Thunder be very, very happy with this win, particularly in the lead up to the game with what happened with the flight being cancelled. They had players at the airport 6 this morning. So to come through and break through any lethargy that might have come from that, a real good job. I think Xavier Clark would be breathing a sigh of relief, because they've done it against a team that threw everything at them.
Yeah, and you know what that does, Stan? That builds mental toughness, because if you can be strong enough to be able to cope with whatever happens. And that's when you play at AFL level, that's the sort of toughness I'm talking about. And doesn't matter what happens before the game or, you know, during the week, you are mentally tough to be able to cope with it. And look, they proved something probably to themselves, perhaps. I don't know. I'm not too sure about that. But I'm sure ex-Clark, you know, the coaching staff and all the Thunder people, now knowing they were, 6 o'clock this morning? You know, it's a long day, mate. So at the end of the day, this game will make them more stronger for leading up to the finals.
Yeah, look, I think they probably learned a couple of things tonight. They can overcome some challenges, and they can win without big games from some blokes that we normally expect big games from. Cameron Islett fairly quiet tonight. Chris Dunn only kicked the one goal.
You know,
they've been carrying the side for a few years. I reckon Xavier Clark would be pretty happy that the team still managed to get over the line when they've had quiet ones, because we expect that they'll come back and be at their best in the finals as well. So to know other players can step up when they're down a little bit, I think it's a good sign for the team as well.
That's great. And, you know, you've still got blokes to come back in it. You've got Shannon Rowley to still come back. And, you know, I mean, just off the top of my head, I can't think of any other blokes just quickly. But, look, there's blokes to come back in, and you know what? As a coach, that's what you want, because you want blokes to earn their spot. And if they have to earn their spot, you know what? you're going to win more often than losing.
Well, they've won tonight, Thunder, 15-14, 104 to the Southport Sharks, 13-8-86. Been great to be able to call a game with you, my old mate. We've called a few over the years and from this same spot, normally a bit lower.
Well, we're normally sitting on the back of a Toyota in the back and doing it on the radio. But look, brother, I really enjoyed it with you today. And it's funny, I mentioned to someone today and I said to him, look, I'm going to be commentating with the bloke that mentored me 15 years ago. And, brother, I don't say that lightly. You know me. When I say something, I mean it. And I just want to say thank you for what you did for me. You know, I've been calling the last 10 years with NERS. I've done 3 grand finals. So I'm getting a bit emotional, brother. Thank you. I really loved that tonight. It was great.
Been a pleasure, Gilly. I've always enjoyed sitting down and watching a game of footy next to you, mate. And you're one of the greats of Central Australian footy, what you've done for footy here. Just can't be doubted, mate. So great to sit next to you again. Can't wait to see you back in Alice Springs next time around.
And yeah.
Great to see Alice Springs send Thunder towards the finals with a win.
Yeah, all the best, Thunder, too, eh?
Bye from us.